dare to enter the mayhem.
Who dares to enter the mayhem?
Get ready to rock. Okay, hello everybody. Welcome to the Guilty Gear stream. We're currently starting with the 19 versus 19 team exhibition, Team White and Team Red. The teams were made kind of randomly depending on player seating. Right now, Resell has won the first game against Ice Critty. The player right now against Resell is not Ice Critty, it's actually Pitt, German Shin player. So let's see how the game goes. All of these games are going to be first to one, selected by team captains. The players are selected by team captains. Okay, Pit getting 6p in, gets hit by the mini frost. Okay, nice control there, nice space control like that from Resell right now. Okay, Pit gets the pressure in, teleport. Tried to slide in, but excellent bomb right there from Resell stops him. Oh, very nice, very nice. I'm not sure if that was intentional, but the Big Driver actually stopped the bomb because Big Driver in itself is a projectile. But at the end, Resell uses 6P to poke out Spit. 6P is one of the... Not only is it a great anti-air, but it's also an incredibly fast poke. I believe it's just one frame slower than 5P, so it's like 7-frame poke with gigantic hitbox. Really good button. Okay, Pit gets a corner combo. Didn't convert after the overhead. Teleport of Resell gets some space back again. Oh, far slash into Hammer. Great RNG right there. Oh, unfortunately doesn't punish going my way. Goes teleport into command grab. Let's see if Pit can actually get the turn now. Tries to poke him out with the big drivers. But he's really low on food gauge right now. He needs to eat. And he chooses completely wrong spot. The only bad spot there was blocks the bomb. Didn't want to go in. Okay, yet another bomb. And he unfortunately jumps into it because of the air dash. Oh, and here's the super. Oh my god, so lucky, so lucky. Pitt just got so lucky in there. Okay, back to the game. Pitt's in the corner right now. Mini Faust covering him. No contest by throw or any button whatsoever. Yes, Mini Faust right now completely saved Faust. Mini Faust is one of the best items Faust has. Such a good item. He moves so slow and just crawls on the floor. Not much you can do at that moment. Okay, gets the basic combo down. Replenishes food gauge. And there's Mini Faust again. Okay. Tries to be real evasive right now. Let's see if Pitt can change this. Gets me to 2K. No knockdown, unfortunately, for him. Gets Big Driver. Here's just one more hit. Oh, unfortunately, he got hit by 2H into Pogo. Oh, well played by both players right now. Okay, score 2-0 for my boys, Team White. We're seeing our boy Maho Shoujo going in. Riku's Rebirth punished Shoujo. Not really a Guilty Gear player, but rather anime player in general. So let's see how well he fares against Resell's Faust. Hello, stream. Shout outs to my mom. Shout outs to my boys. Okay, the teams are pretty big. There are 19 players on each side. They can be found on my Twitter. And if somebody could post the link of the screenshot to the stream chat, that would be really good. It can be found on either mine or Mick's Twitter. All the players were put in the teams according to the seeding. scored from 1 to 5. Oh, he's actually going with Raven. Nice. Raven being a completely new character, so Rizal probably not really knowing what to expect. And neither do I actually know what to expect. Okay, starts with a backdash. Uses darts to keep him out. Yep, darts actually slow your momentum, just like you can see right now. Not only is Foss air dash slow in general, but when he gets hit with the dart, he gets incredibly slow. Okay, gets the anti-air 6B. No knockdown afterwards. Oh, gets the anti-air command grab. Beautiful work right there. Oh, tried to go into command grab yet again. Raven's command grab is very unique in the sense that it works in a very specific range, but not any closer. Like, there's a very specific range further from it. It's more of a mid-screen poke, which is kind of unblockable. Okay, hits 2H counter hits. Good burst right there. In a very good burst point, right after 2H. Okay, gets a bump. Anti-air 5P. And that was the anti-air command grab. Completely whiffed. Okay, both players have so much meter. Gets hit with a trampoline. Oh, 2H. Okay, blocks the bomb. Hammer out. Oh, Rizal getting a gold burst. Super toss. Oh, very nice cross under right there. This. Very nice cross under right there. Oh, and he hits the command grab. No follow-up afterwards, since he's only level 1. Oh, very nice jump cancel right there. Very nice play by Rikus. Jump cancel into the bomb. Oh, counter hit 6P launch. Very nice. Gets knocks down the jump D. Meaty fireball. But unfortunately, didn't follow up with any Oki. He gets counter hit 6P again. Launch. Command grab reset. Okay, this is so much in Rikus' favor right now. Gets another command grab. Nice play right there from Rikus. Very nice play. Okay, Scorpion 2-1 in favor of Team White. Raven being a completely new character. I mean, I've played about 10 games against him, maybe even less. And so far, the character looks actually pretty strong. No idea if he's top tier, obviously, or how strong he is. But he's definitely not weak, definitely not. Okay, Rico's opponent right now is, I believe, Chasserine. But I saw him play Potemkin and Kai. And I believe these two actually play together from time to time. Okay. Good. Yes, PS4, amazing console. Thank you, Sony. What looks really strong about Raven is the fact that he can actually reset his pressure, because he can cancel a block string into the dart, YRC at the end, and just air dash back in. And then it becomes, you can obviously charge blitz out or blitz out, but it's still a risk. Like, so you can just kind of reset, keep resetting the pressure as long as he has meter, which is really good. Yeah, it goes with Potemkin. Let's see how Potemkin fares in this matchup. Okay, uses the Eclipse color. Okay, Rico's just getting another command grab. I think someone is keeping the secret that you can actually jump out of the command grab. They try to anti-air with it. Air just glided in with the air dash. I believe it's like 4 hits that Raven does. Definitely a lot of them. Okay, gets the air combo and knocks down with JD, second hit. And actually in a masochism. Masochism stance. Very nice. He poked it far slash. Couldn't get a hammer fall. Okay, let's see what the Oki is. Went high. Another fireball setup. Went low this time. Going back to Lou. Okay. Riku's right now controlling space very well using 2S and 2D. Oh, gets a command grab yet again. Tried to go into masochism stance, didn't actually work for him. Hello, Fush.
Fush joined the frame because I'm from the different team and I'm okay. Here to ensure unbiased commenting.
Yes, very unbiased. No bias happening here.
I mean, I'm team red, and red is always the better color, as everybody knows.
Really?
I mean, red always wins. It's red is the leader.
Really? So you believe that red encourages courage?
Red is anger,
courage,
strength. White is just nothing.
Okay.
Nothing in comparison to the almighty red.
Okay.
And as you saw just now. Red prevails.
Yes.
Even this shitty eclipse color will not save white.
Your eclipse colors are so amazing. So amazing. And it's so good to just play against it. Like, you feel so good. Like, one thing is just watching them, but actually playing against it is so horrible.
So, up next for red is?
McVillain, I believe.
McVillain?
Yes. I believe.
Yeah, it's McVillain. It wasn't my poots, I believe. Yeah, it was McVillain.
He plays Potdomkin, right? Chumpkin.
I believe. I'm not so sure.
Okay.
But you just saw Potdomkin and Raven. I think Raven.
You think it's an easy matchup for Raven?
I mean, he's a kebab character, right? And
kebab character?
Keep out.
Keep away.
Keep away character.
I don't know if he really is. I mean, he has the potential, obviously.
But
Potemkin can flick any dart. And
if he's able to.
And I'm pretty sure that Raven will have problems against flicks because he can't really, like, micro dash and just. Like, dashing with him inhibits his movement options because he just dashes.
Yeah, because his dash is so awkward.
Yeah, because his dash is so awkward. And same with air dash, because the air dash is actually glide.
Yeah.
And he cannot cancel it. Like, even if Raven does YRC during. He keeps going. He doesn't really stop. So I'm pretty sure that Potemkin's flicked super huge fireball is a pretty huge threat against Raven.
Okay. Yeah.
At least it should be.
Yeah, it should be. It should be. But he has also like non-projectile pokes, right? So he has fast slash into his 2H.
2H is gigantic. He borrowed that from Faust. At pretty much Faust button.
Yeah?
Pretty much the same.
It also low profiles.
I have no idea about that, but it's.
Like 2H wins against projectiles from Raven.
Okay.
It just wins against like his own projectile, for instance.
I see.
So it's pretty huge. It's really good, like, ground cover move. But it's like long animation, right? Extremely
2H?
Long.
Yeah,
extremely long animation.
Yep, and it's not even easy to convert off of.
It's just I don't know.
Forward circle forward S or something.
Forward circle forward S. Yeah, I don't know the name of
something like that. I believe.
Gauss Impulse is the name, I believe.
Okay, so let's see if McVillain can actually make this work.
Goes
and
again.
Air command grab.
Always, he always just presses it. Doesn't care.
Because it's so beautiful.
Okay, does not take the free jump in.
Oh, gets. It's actually countered flick. Oh, nice throw right there.
And because he jumps with the projectile, like, he didn't get knocked down because of the unblockable.
But he got the anti-RCSP bad burst right there. That's what we call a Scandinavian burst. Do you know why?
It's Canadian burst, it's German burst, it's Europe burst.
No, actually, no. This is a very specific reason. I call this a Scandinavian burst because it's high in the north. High up in the north.
All right, that's smart.
Always. Okay, couldn't follow after the glide. Obviously no hate towards Scandinavian players, not at all. It's just geographic.
Yeah,
wording,
I know.
Not to players.
At top. Okay, just goes in.
Meshes 5P out. Or 4P, I'm not sure what the difference is.
Tried to flick, got air.
Okay, let's see what the Oki is. Go slow this time. tried to blitz, but didn't work in his favor.
Didn't hold, and again, present for Potemkin, just went in.
Yep. Both players playing real solid now, trying to stay safe from each other. Oh, just dash 2D right into the slide hat. Okay, let's see if he can. Meshes 4P.
Pick. Yep. And that stance.
Yep, guessed right against the command grab. Gets countered 6, came to Mega Fist.
No busters. Alright, this could have been a buster. Alright, Blender incoming.
Back dash command grab, that's actually pretty, that's very pretty. Burst bait. Gets counter hit just even, this is so much stun damage right now. Doesn't go for Trishula YSC.
Dropkick.
Doesn't dead angle either. Like Raven's Glide, I believe it does 4 hits.
No, his Glide just 1 hit.
No, but afterwards, the follow-up, if he still keeps going.
That's a normal string.
But yeah, but it's usually 3 more buttons.
Yeah, it's 3 more buttons most of the time, yes. So yeah. That it's the true boxing and it doesn't get thrown.
But that's important to know because otherwise you just get hit high if you don't know that. Gets anti-air 6P, knocks down a JD as well. Trying to get on the anti-air command grab.
Air command grab.
Dart YRC. Amazing tool. Dart YRC looks so strong. That angles out. That was, I guess, Hammerfall. Dart in a slide head. Another game won by Riku's Rebirth. Our Maho Shoujo. Representing Hamburg.
Representing guys who never learn.
Isn't that all of us?
No, he really never learns. You tell him stuff, but he doesn't do it. Like, exactly like this, you saw it like 5 times. Not 5, but a few times. Like dash and command grab.
I would get hit by it, because I'm a scrub. I would get hit by it every single time.
No, it wouldn't.
I would never. Believe me. I know myself better than you know me.
Do you really believe so?
I hope so.
So, Sinuel, Jan, now, like Jacko, pretty good actually so far.
Yes, definitely another player to underestimate.
He knows how to press profiling moves with this character. And
he knows which buttons to press. That's also a very important thing to know.
Let's see.
Both players probably have no idea about the matchup.
And she has her shield. The character has the shield.
Yes,
the shield.
Aegis shield should definitely help against Raven, for sure. Okay, gets 2 houses.
DP. If in doubt, DP out.
Gets command grab against Masochism. Oh my god, the damage afterwards. Thanks, Masochism stance. Okay, boosts up the minions to be faster.
Oh, now he's in the hell.
Yep, this is going to be real tough. Gets meter back, so he's probably going. Yep. This goes into super.
And now
this is pretty much a block drink infinite, isn't it? Because he gets meter right back.
Oh, he just went for self explode. Doesn't care. And he again had the meter for the super.
Exactly. Yeah, she can loop it over and over again. It's incredible. The meter gain of all new characters is insane. Just look at Johnny. Johnny's meter gain completely ridiculous. K's got the K house out. I tried to anti, but unfortunately couldn't. Gets 1 more house.
And
boosts up the minions.
Gets jump out.
Not yet. First. Still only level 1 house in front of him. Destroys it.
Blender goes for somewhat okay.
Oh, and there's the command grab.
Mashing super. Minions saves the block string.
Okay, the house is still there. The house can actually still keep him alive. And the house is actually level 3 right now.
Yeah,
this can be horrible. This can end up very bad if he gets a command grab.
Yep.
So the way Jekyll works is that she's like a mixture of fighting games and strategies. In the sense that like she puts tower defense on the ground itself. And she actually has even like specific skills to her that are on cooldown and stuff. Like, it's pretty much just from RPG or strategy game. Really interesting character. Oh, the darts actually take care of the houses. That's yep. so good.
They have no low profile
hit. Yes, that's good.
Box, so you can hit them with anything that is somewhat on like yeah. medium level.
Yeah, that's amazing.
Height.
That's amazing. That's really good for Raven.
But you cannot hit them.
Oh, gets another command grab.
You cannot get the low minions with low profiling.
I understand.
Hitting moves.
And gets the super.
Hellfire.
Pretty okay damage.
Pretty
okay.
Pretty okay.
Decent.
Okay, don't drop the combo. Drops the combo.
Two
D's. Doesn't care. I don't care if you're on the ground. I'm just going to come out off the ground.
That was Street Fighter 4 setup. Like, with a button and then do something, it's unblockable. Okay, he's going in.
What?
And he just gets the glide. Another game won by Rikus.
One. It's the protector of the night. With his Backenzwange and grausam Impuls. Ein gebrechlich Licht.
What's gebrechlich Licht?
A fragile light.
What does fragile light have in common with this? Why fragile light?
Like, I don't know, shit. And it's even like not like, okay.
Like is the name of the move?
That's the name of the roof. Gebrechlich Licht. Gebrechlich Licht is like the small projectile.
Okay.
And it's fragile light in German.
Also, it seems that Adult Benis is going on the stream. Oh no, he's not. He's not, unfortunately. Unfortunately, Adult Benny's not on stream yet. It's actually Basta Wolf.
Basta Wolf?
Damn. Yes, Basta Wolf, Eno player.
Oh.
He plays a decent Eno. Knows her stuff.
Yeah, boils down to the fact if he can just combo and go into knockdown and
definitely
continue.
Yeah, but I'm also interested in seeing the matchup because it might be that Raven will have a lot of problems with horizontal chemical love.
Yeah.
I'm really interested to see how he can handle with it.
I think, like, her hover dash
can... And also notes as well, because they would go right into the block.
Yeah, they have both, like, low hover dashes and can stuff both with the projectile stuff, yes. Like, she can chemical love, which would always hit him, and...
Yes, summon. So let's see how this works out. I'll try to go right into command grab. Gets knocked down into notes. It goes overhead. Unfortunately, doesn't finish the combo.
And that's what's important. Again, fishing with that command grab.
Nice.
Stroke the penis.
Oh, come on. Come on. I would let her stroke my big tree. Okay, blocks and press, jumps out of the command grab.
Maybe he will notice that he always jumps out. Finally goes for like continued
maybe.
Pressure. I'll see.
But maybe a good option against Raven's command grab would be to just instant air backdash.
Yeah, that will always work.
Yes.
It's more like what he can do also instead of the command. So, right, he can just go for the projectile, YRC, and continue. If done right.
Okay, gets a knockdown. Let's see what the Oki is. They just dash in 2K throw. Tries to get on the command grab yet again.
Oh, almost hit.
Mashes out the 5P bar, eh?
Ah, doesn't block.
Dart. Rest in peace.
Okay, nobody knows how to confirm the air dash hit when they are in the air.
Seems to be the case. Go slow this time. Let's see if we can follow it up.
Starting that pressure soon.
Here's the knockdown. Let's see what the Oki is now.
Goes for the
JD ender.
That was like five overheads for?
Yeah, 5-6. Eno's makes up pretty incredible.
6P just too early.
Oh, gets wake up thrown. Throws in Guilty Gear have one frame startup. They're extremely instant. And they are mostly used as punishers. Or even as a reversal option. Oh, just... Yes, this is one
Dash
I'm talking about.
And the air command grab.
And gets chemical upped.
Right.
Yeah, 2H. Try to anti-SXP.
Work, but no lunch.
Gets STBT in.
this.
Okay, this might be it. This might be it, actually.
No! Drops.
It actually drops the combo. Yeah. He actually hits him out of the air. Now JD knockdown. Horizontal chemical love. Still a crouch on the chemical love.
Yeah, he just needs one hit, right? So
yes, only
smash
one
that.
Hit. Yes. And he gets the JH in. Buster Wolf really happy about it. Someone finally taking down Rikus.
So who's next for the best team?
For the best team, you mean ours? We don't have anyone other. This guy is enough to beat you.
We'll see about that. Okay, I think there's a council on who's sent to next. The guy who will OCV everybody. Starting now.
Who?
You'll see.
We'll see, okay.
I mean, look at Denza, he's like calculating every aspect of your team.
So it's actually Ekusu. Not really a Guilty Gear player. Mostly played Blaze Blue before. No, I'm not saying he's bad or anything.
He rarely plays overall these days. But
yes.
Oh no, Ekusu. Kicks.
Oh, Kicks. So it's actually Kex in the end, a Johnny player.
Cupcakes. Let's show him that Smithbinder cancel.
He'll get blown up.
Strong or
I actually don't know how this matchup looks like in Xrd.
I'm also like unsure.
Because I remember how it was in the Accent Core in Plus R, but maybe things changed. Maybe.
And how were things?
Pretty bad, because like the spot where Johnny wanted to be in neutral was right where she could like poke him out with chemical off all the time. So he was like really, really annoyed by that. Obviously his combo hurts a lot though.
Yeah, of course.
And especially now in Xrd where he just gets random any hit in.
He goes for random.
What's her standard? What's Johnny's standard damage from a throw and unblockable? That's his standard damage.
That's the damage, yes.
Like how much damage does he get? He gets about one or two unblockables. Okay.
But does 3K beat Chemical Love? It should be. It should, right?
6K?
6K.
Probably yes.
Yeah.
And it will also be countered because Chemical Love is for the entire time in countered state. And 6K on countered is untackable until the ground. So yeah. He can get huge conversions.
Yeah.
Like
right.
Coin, PMS Finder, right in the corner carry.
Right, let's see. First button, fast slash.
Just do it.
Drops the combo. What? This was not supposed to happen.
Okay, he gets the first coin. No, no conversion after 5H. Gets another knockdown. Let's see what he goes for. 2S. Okay, he went low this time. Oh, resets the pressure, resets the mix-up with an overhead. Good burst right there from Kex. He needs it.
Unfortunately, dropped.
Okay, this should be it, actually. This should be it. Yep.
Well, that was like overhead, and didn't block at all. Unfortunately.
It's welcome to Ino, the character of nothing but mix-ups. And we call it mix-ups, but it's just pure pure guessing game.
Like it's unreactable.
Like there's not even any conditioning happening. It's just guessing game, really. But the character does have issues in the neutral, and a lot of them. He jumps over the note. Yep, there it is. My favorite thing. Chemical of YRC dash.
There's not really much you can do about it.
I believe you actually can, but you need.
You
to
can
be really
counter
tight.
Blitz. You can if you have a good 6P, you can 6P.
Yes, but it's really tight. And
yeah, it's really
and
tight.
You need to expect it. Really hard to react to. Yeah, Buster Wolf looking really dominant.
So, who's next?
Okay, so who? Who do you think your team should choose to beat Buster Wolf?
And our Ino player, Zenza.
Oh, okay, Mirror.
Mirror. Fight fire with fire.
Must be very fun.
I imagine the bullshit, man. The first one who gets a knockdown gets all the fun.
Okay.
But I don't believe they will send Senza because he has a bigger number, I believe. Numbers are everything, even today.
Case.
You have seen the list with the numbers?
Yes.
There was a list. I it was just explained to me, so that's why I was like, well, numbers?
Yeah, it's seeding pretty much.
Now it's, I believe that's Matza. Matza.
Captain Atom.
Captain Atom? Captain Atom. Who? Leo. Okay, Leo player.
Former Faust.
Former Faust Leo player, okay. Let's see if he can scrub this.
Do you know what character he plays? Amelia!
Leo. Oh, and both are struggling before match, showing their dominance, their manly animal dominance over the other. We go for Leo. He will, like, cross up, destroy.
When it comes to Leo, I know. I have actually heard that this is a very bad matchup for Leo. Coming from my Czech. From like one of the Czech Leo players. In his opinion, it's pretty much unwinnable for Leo. I have no idea whether that's true or not.
But Chemical Love should work fine again.
Chemical Love should be amazing. Oh. In general, Leo's movement is slow, so he really needs to poke her out.
Gets low profile.
He gets back dash. Yep, there's the first Leo knockdown. Burst right there. Good burst.
Well, not a bad decision overall. Just
August countered far slash.
Cross up and jumps out. Yep. Should have gone instant. Extends, drops the combo.
It actually looks like he baited a burst, to be honest.
Yeah, a burst that does not exist.
Because he immediately went into FD.
Yeah. Seems too forgotten.
Yep.
And yeah, just go. Didn't want to take it.
And that was burst safe? Come on.
That's a character.
Amazing.
Anything
amazing character. Amazing character.
Always the first jump and it's always like safe against anything. Against counter assault, against burst, against DP.
Amazing.
Good character. Just gets stunned easily.
Yep. And not only stunned. Also, she also loses in neutral easy against a lot of characters.
Unblockables? Nice. Now he
actually did not bait the burst. Okay, Buster Wolf having a lot of meter.
Oh,
uses the dust.
Backdash is nice. Oh, well.
Nice NGF5H. No conversion afterwards, though. He gets huge Sonic Boom. Oh my god, the range in Chemical Love. Try to parry Chemical Love back.
Oh, nice.
Very nice. Well played by Captain Atom right there. Very nice play. At the end, what he tried to go for? He was trying to parry her Chemical Love, the horizontal long projectile.
Yeah, to get the reject, somewhat reject state.
Not only somewhat, it actually like travels back because it's a projectile.
It travels back?
The shield? When it's
I know, it reflects projectiles,
he throws back the projectiles.
And how does this look? Like?
It's basically a beam, so she gets beamed back. And immediately gets knocked down.
Does the beam look also as Chemical Love?
Like yes. Like it's immediately. And she immediately gets knocked down.
That's ridiculous.
Zato has actually the same thing. And you can see Zato players just like run in. Drunk out shade.
Just press it. Do it. Do your Chemical Love. Yeah. Nice. Awesome. Never seen that.
Okay. Well, it's not a matchup you often see, especially in Europe. You very rarely see Zato's.
Yeah.
Well, you do because you play me all the time.
Yeah, when in Europe, there's one guy, and one guy plays this character, and now everybody knows this character because one guy plays the character. Because we are only 10 guys.
Come on, 19 versus 19, so there's 38.
Yeah, we
38
are,
of us.
We are 38 today. So that's Chimera. For white, pressing European buttons for a Japanese version. Jacko against Leo.
Okay. Now Jacko, okay, let's see how this works. This is actually a pretty annoying matchup for Leo, mostly due to the fact...
Which matchup is not annoying for Leo?
Well, most of them are, but the thing is that... on Jacko, you can't really Unga properly. Because she has a DP on a button, like literally a DP button.
Yeah, no cross up. No cross up. You lose your DP input.
Just press a button. So he has, so needs to bait it out all the time, especially in stance. Needs to keep going for that parry.
Oh, both very cautious, not pressing anything.
Probably try to bait out the flash kick. Yep, there's the DP I'm talking about. Amazing input, just 2D. It's probably come from Persona, to be honest.
The one button DP is the bonus thing.
No, Persona were two button DPs.
Yeah,
two,
but you could also...
No, listen to me. But the thing is that Arx just realized this mistake. This was not an easy input to do, so they just changed it to one button.
Exactly.
But one button.
Good decisions.
goes for overhead yet again. Good blocks right there. Gets command grab. Let's see. It doesn't set up any houses, actually. That's surprising. It's really surprising to see.
Okay, doesn't use this knockdown, no. I'd get
okay, couldn't burst at the end. I'm really surprised he's not throwing out houses when he actually has the chance to.
Yeah, well, it's really autopilot, really, right? You get the knockdown, you put a house down, that's what you do. You should do.
Or even if you have, like, space to breathe in neutral.
No, this was... Yeah, since...
Or maybe he's scared of Sonic Booms? I don't know.
DP maybe. But that's not... You can't put out the house and it's
okay,
safe.
Gets a command grab. Yet again, no house. Oh, it gets the... No follow-up after the overhead, unfortunately.
Oh! That was hit.
Actually, gets a super afterwards.
Oh, it's still hit. Even though it was behind them. And that's it.
The hitbox on the X is magical. It's just pure magic. And the best thing is when he screws it up, you're behind him and it hits you anyways. That's the best. That's my favorite thing. It's straight from KOF, straight from King of Fighters.
Yeah, you got hit by the first hit, now you get hit by every hit. No excuse.
You don't get hit by anything, so you get hit by the last hit. That's usually how it works.
So now for White, Lunatic Soul. And he plays Soul? As a Soul?
Yes, Soul player. Actually not a bad player at all.
Very aggressive. Hey God.
He actually beats Ken Deep.
He just said I should turn left so I'm better seen. Yeah, look at my beautiful face.
You're beautiful.
I'm so sexy. And very attractive.
Yes, you are.
My hair is so full and bendy.
That's why I sit next to you.
I know. Even though we are mortal enemies this day.
Mortal. Immortal enemies.
And we'll die by each other's head maybe at some point.
Maybe.
Who's your anchor?
I don't know.
Have you decided on an anchor?
Not really.
Okay. I mean, we just sent Rasta last, of course. And
okay. And probably...
He would save us.
You also have Pedia on your team.
Your cute boy is nothing against the porn star, Rasta.
But we have other players against Rasta. And you have Pedia, not we. You have Pedia.
We have Pedia? Okay. Yeah. Okay, then Pedia will not save us.
Okay.
He will just DP you and you're fucked.
Benten Sama! Oh, gets a counter in Fafnir. Real pain coming in right now.
But it's not enough.
Yeah, just one more hit.
Goes for empty low.
Okay, traded with 5k. And just blitzes Berserker Slash. Good decision.
Good decisions.
And Flash kicks him out of the air. Just the most unsafe tech trap you can think of.
Fast. It's pretty fast. This was like 20 seconds. 20
yep,
seconds.
Really fast game. Both players being so aggressive, just keep pressing buttons all the time. Unga!
Oh.
He leaves the stance.
Yeah, he's
charged Sonic Boom.
Not aggressive, didn't chase at all.
Okay, very nice knockdown right there.
He extends, and here we go.
Yeah, good pressure right there from Captain Atom. You can also see that he used the 2D to catch out Eddie Mesh.
Empty jump low again.
Okay, let's see what the mix-up is right now. Low air dash into SD.
No burst.
Crowd getting hyped for dust loops. Couldn't follow it, unfortunately, into real knockdown. It's charged Sonic Boom out. It actually hits him. Oh my god, what a beautiful burst base using the parry.
Unfortunately, he didn't get the conversion.
Unfortunately not. Gets Fafnir.
No counter.
Oh, this can kill. Yep, he kills.
And so Captain has...
Finally, Team White winning for once. Lunatic Soul, best player, I'm telling you. He's the best player, he's going to win this entire thing. Believe me.
I believe
you. I want to be on the team where Lunatic Soul is. Oh, good that I am. Good that I am.
Yeah. Yes, he's just a bad guy.
Bad guy.
Yeah.
Also, we're getting Leechy, Faust player. Do you think Leechy can do this?
I'm currently really thinking hard about it. I believe yes.
But come on, we have Lunatic Soul, and Lunatic Soul is clearly the best right here.
Yeah, but he claims himself he's the Tobosal.
What's a Tobosal?
Turbo Soul, a soul that does not care and goes in and...
Oh, Turbo up. Soul.
Turbo Soul.
Okay.
And if I didn't take that word, I would also think Leechy is a Turbo Faust. And...
Can you be Turbo with Faust?
Yeah, by pressing Drill Kick a lot.
Okay.
And I think that should work. Could work. We'll see. But
I mean, this matchup is... considered in Faust's favor, I believe.
Yeah, it is, because Faust can keep Soul out really, yeah, really hard.
Really well. Actually, trades a Gunflame with the fishing pole. Okay, chases him down, right, using tech traps.
Oh,
very
bait.
Nice, very nice burst bait.
Yeah, it doesn't care. Just he has the meter, spend the meter to...
To go in. He needs to go in. Bandit Fafnirbringer, actually.
Right.
Counter hit 6P. I'm telling you, man, I just told you, Lunatic Soul, best player right here. I want to be on his team. And good that I am on his team.
Jumps out, gets it.
Okay, FD's Fafnir. And he gets actually hit by his own slide head item. Oh, God, nice anti-air 2H.
Unfortunately, drops.
Oh, actually, oil underwater looks really weird. I just noticed that, like, the oil
underwater... Yeah, I just saw it myself, like, wow.
And
good engine, good game, good looks. This game worked on release.
Kono game, kuso janai, yo.
It's us.
Okay,
nice sweep.
It's OTG Pogo.
My
meteor saving. Oh, come on, Lunatic Soul, you're the best player right here.
Turbo drill, like I said.
Come on, Lunatic Soul is supposed to win this. He's the best player here. I'm so glad I'm on his team. I'm really glad. I'm telling you, he's going to win this. See?
See the high-tech.
See just what I told you.
The high-tech whiff.
Just what I told you. Opens him up with low because he knows he's in his head. Right now, he knows him. He understands him. Okay, he doesn't.
He didn't know that he would burst.
Okay, it's very nice air-to-air jump in P.
Yeah. Just stuffed him right off, out of the air. Doesn't care, just goes for it. And...
Okay. Yeah, as I said, Lunatic Soul, clearly the best player. Clearly.
Strikes fear in the heart of his enemies.
Okay, so who's going to save your team? I wonder.
I wonder too, let's see.
I don't think anybody can save your team.
God can. And by God I mean a Zato player, but we don't have any Zato players.
Unfortunately, that guy's on the other side.
Yeah.
Your immortal enemy.
Kungsta's not present, right? Kungsta's away.
Kungsta, I don't see him, but he's on our team anyways, I think. Oh, so our team has 2 Zaltos, it's amazing.
Rigged. Rigged competitions.
Thank God.
Everywhere.
Thank God. Praise be.
Yeah, really. making their decision carefully.
So who's coming? Who's the next player? Next Spieler.
I mean, we're pretty at the start still, right? 40 players left.
Yeah, right now the score is 6-6, I believe.
Yeah, it's 4-6. So actually, a lot of people still left to kill the soul, take the soul of Lunatic Soul. I think they are searching for the guy who's next. Berat, where's Nächster by us? Where's Nächster? So, next for us is either Bing Gong Healing Care or Mazda. Mazda is like a Ino player. Healing Care, I think he still plays Kai. But nobody can be found at this point.
Oh, so Healing Care is coming.
Yeah, Healing Care.
Hilitzvus. I think we're going to see a few lightsabers. Just a few of them.
Maybe a few greed savers.
Maybe.
Jekko, he's Jekko now? Oh, Jekko.
Okay, I see.
Jekko.
Yet another Jekko.
They all like... I don't know. What's to like about these characters? Tits? Boots?
Ass.
Ass. Okay. But she... Yeah, okay. Yeah, found the circle button. Awesome.
So that's almost the victory right there. Almost victory.
I have not seen Healing Care playing this character.
Neither have I. So let's see what's going to happen. Isn't it 6-6? Isn't it 6-6?
Okay. It's 6-6 now, yeah.
He crosses Lundix all up.
Just does the string. Doesn't care if he hits.
Doesn't right. care about anything. Okay, just smashes out. Abare too stark.
One button DP.
Amazing shit.
Should have pressed DP again.
Yeah, he should.
Oh, stole a soul!
Yep, just like that. Just do it.
Respect the minions.
Okay, gets Aegis shield up. Oh, hits him with the dust.
Ah, minion screwed up though.
Yep, the side of combo. Okay, gets dust loop. Drops the dive kick.
This is whiff, yeah.
That's most likely because Jekko is a lightweight character. So he most likely did not do the proper conversion against her.
What's he going to do? Buffs the minions?
Oh, unfortunately, he does not get the knockdown of the command grab. Oh, and there's just the DP.
Oh, my. Ready or not?
Okay.
Low profiles.
Knocks him out of Fafnir. Oh, does not follow up with the counter jump in D. Due to the wall bounce feature. Just Fafnir, just do it.
Just
do it. It destroys the house as well. 5H most likely trying to throw him. He just runs after him. Oh, thank you, minion.
Good job. Again, good job.
Thank you, minion.
That's good. Oh, no, you all cannot get hit by it.
Yep.
Oh.
You got MVP,
that's like
minion.
Chaos. Didn't press anything.
Yeah.
Run up super works.
Yep, everybody's favorite super. Just TP, just do it. Okay, he does not set up the other houses. Oh, unfortunately, didn't press anything afterwards.
That's it.
And Lunatic Soul, just as I said, the best player. Clearly the best player right here. Clearly.
So who's next? Who's next? Who's next? They said Mazda. Where is he?
Kunis? I don't know. But I see Adult Benny's over there. Getting ready to play.
He will save the day, surely, with that check power. Yes. Will you give him your sombrero?
Adult Benny's?
Yeah.
For sure. Okay, so the next players, still nobody coming up. Everybody just too scared of Lunatic Soul.
Oh, Filzerlos, come on, Filzer.
Okay, a May player coming up.
Yeah, nice.
Filzer.
He can destroy souls, as we have seen.
Yes, that was very hype. But maybe Lunatic Soul can make this work. Just maybe.
And they still know each other, so they played.
Do they?
Against the guy. Oh, yeah, okay. They're both from the same spot.
Okay, I see.
Okay, SeaWorld against... No, no, Queen. SeaWorld against Queen.
They tried the 3K.
Oh, it was pretty goodly well-spaced.
Yeah, very well-spaced. Very well-spaced. Okay, Phil's are controlling the space very well right now. Okay, gets knocked down using the 3K. Oh, blocks it does. Very nice block.
Burst. That's really tempting to burst the counter at Fafnir, but you shouldn't. Never.
That is true. That is very true.
Okay, Dolphin set up. Just DP. If in doubt, DP out.
Yep. Lunatic Souls knows how to play fighting games.
L grab. Might could have also combo there. I was too high.
Oh, he was too high, yes.
Okay, nice counter poke with the 5k, unfortunately.
Unfortunately, 2D is a way better button than almost every button in the game.
Okay, just...
anti-F 5k. Very surprising anti-F 5k worked. Are you not surprised?
I'm surprised that the cleanup beat like 2H for me. Come on! Do it! Just press that one button that is good with May.
You mean any S or H button?
Any S or H button. Mostly in the air.
Yep.
And he's going for it. Like, oh, full charge.
Yep.
Then anything.
Gets DP knockdown. OCG 2Ks. Okay, no challenge after the block bandit revolver. Good burst off the Fafnir right there. Oh my god, that was a pretty setup.
That was fucky.
That was pretty.
Funky, very funky. And, yeah.
Let's wake up
if
super.
If he DPs, you DP him. Dolphin got grilled, let's say.
Yeah, pretty much.
Okay, go for. Yeah, nice. He made the DP save, Dolphin.
Yes, DP save setups.
Safe jump. Extension cross up.
Very nice cross up and very nice block on it.
Nicely, very well done.
Nicely played by Filster right now. Nicely played.
Okay, now the soul gets destroyed. The madness, the lunatic.
You mean the lunatic
puns,
soul?
Please.
The soul of lunatics?
Yeah, right.
A very nice effort right there.
Very good. Knew that he would dash.
Finally contests the bandage revolver and block.
Ah, went for that command grab even though the dolphin hit.
God. I'm also again surprised 5K worked. Very surprising.
He always goes for the low, the empty low.
Yeah, so far he has mostly been going for empty low.
Nice conversion. Okay, burst.
Okay, Felser trying to control space right now, gets actually corner knockdown.
Balls.
Uses beach
knockdown.
Ball.
Wow, good confirm.
Yes, very good.
And, yeah!
I just goes twice for an overhead.
Very smart.
Yep, good play right there by Felser. Lunatic Soul finally fallen.
The Messiah is dead. And now comes Axel. Oh,
It's a Chargy's Axel. Austrian player, actually.
Austrian player. Chargy, yes. Plays Axel. Plays him good, actually. And this will be the completely opposite of what we just saw.
Complete opposite.
Like, no.
Oh, Chargy's on my team, so I'm going to be biased. Okay. You know the Sparrowhawk song, right?
You can... When it happens, it happens.
Of course.
I don't know. I don't believe he does it so much as other players I will not name do it. But it's actually what you should do, right? Always when you have the strides, you should do it. There's no reason not to. That's the thing.
Exactly.
There's no reason not to do Sparrowhawk.
But actual players will tell you no. Sparrowhawk is situational and risky.
Yeah, of course. It's like...
It's like full screen 50-50.
It's like Fafnir, right? No, it's totally risky to press it.
Yes, exactly. Like sometimes you get jabbed out of it, you eat 10 damage.
Oh, wow! You mean you can count that in a way?
Sparrowhawk stance.
Okay, setting up stuff. Again with these fucking headsets.
Magic. Do you think the same thing as in the finals is going to be happening right now?
Depends on how we send our guys, right?
People go in, so it works. Okay, let's not make that work.
Do we get the beamer? That's the point at that question. I believe not.
I have no idea.
Nobody cares, I believe. That's why we have to stream.
Yep.
And that people can watch. But we still have the headset struggle.
The worst kind of struggle.
Well, I personally just usually use headsets because I don't know, it like blocks all the other noises.
Yeah, I mean that's kind of the main point, to be honest.
Some guys say they play without when they hear the sound from just the main stage, right? Because they don't care. I'm just like, I don't know.
Meh.
Try to isolate myself.
I understand.
We have a random shaman in the crowd.
I guess.
Pokken! Support our sponsors. Pokken. Play Pokken. It's very successful. An arcade.
Is it?
No, it's not.
Yeah, that's what I heard.
it gets bodied by the Zidia, the arcade game. Okay, nice. Gets a combo. Again, Scandinavian burst.
Yep, exactly. Okay, gets knocked down with the Instinct.
He didn't go for the cross-up ball. He should have gone for the cross-up ball.
Okay, hit it 2H. Tries to backstab.
Then instant block.
Okay, nice anti-air using 5P right there. Very nice.
Oh, misses.
Oh, good throw.
Good throw.
Unfortunately, didn't link after the 6H. Gets hit by the dust.
And May.
Dust being universal overheads in Guilty Gear.
And gets the knockdown corner.
From the end. Oh, there's a Ben Densama.
It was good to Pete.
Oh my god. Thank you, Beast Yamato. Thank you.
SeaWorld Super. Okay, Funky, that.
The backstab.
Yeah, I mean,
yeah, sometimes the backstab is not really
yeah,
a cross-up.
Yeah, that was no cross-up. Yep. I think that was pretty like, you didn't know what was
yes,
the
most likely.
Stuff. Okay, get the conversion. Yes. And knock down this.
Yep, there it is.
Oh, nice. Reject. Gets the corner. Goes for the, yeah, goes for the bomber commas. Alts. Jumped over the Ransom follow-up. That's what people really make the mistake against Axel. Like they try to go over air Ransom, but with air dash, right?
Yep.
And then you just get
and
hit by the follow-up.
And then up follow-up, yep. But you can actually go over it if you use wire
double jump.
If you use double jump, or because if you do a double jump, then he can just do nothing and then
you meant to.
But what you can actually do is air dash YRC. That's a very good option, actually.
Yeah, but I mean, you can block then. That's the thing. But the follow-up is also like -7, and if you block it...
Yeah, but it pushes out really far.
Yeah.
Like, really far.
But any space you make good on Axel is always good.
He's a 6-H, 6-H.
Dolphin gets...
Yep, gets ransomed.
Oh!
Okay. Yep. Charge Blitz is out. Wrong timing, unfortunately.
No full screen follow-up attacks for Dust, for Blitz.
Yep. That's the
if in doubt.
He just double jumps over.
That's it. He cannot do anything anymore. I mean, he could have deed, but
probably.
He could. It might have worked. By some miracle.
Well, sometimes you can actually burst Sparrowhawk.
Yeah,
Sparrowhawk
is not... But he burst before. Try to burst it.
Yeah, it's not even a projectile.
No, it's a...
It's normal. It's actually a normal strike.
I believe I also golden busted a Sparrowhawk once.
Yes, it is possible. Okay, so Ekusus coming up. An Alphalt player.
Yep.
So let's see how he's able to fare with Alphalt in the Axel matchup.
Let's see if he baits the DP correctly.
Actually, one of the greatest things Alphalt has in this matchup... is that it's bad idea for Axel to like push around in the corner like full screen, which is usually what he wants to against other characters. But against Alphalt, if he, for example, does Ransom up follow-up and pushes her truly out full screen, it's actually bad because that's a free rifle entry stance for her. She can just go right into the sniper rifle and completely outzone Axel himself.
Yeah, that's ridiculous, full screen zoning game with perfect reload sniper rifle.
Obviously, you need to be good to use the sniper rifle properly,
and
because you actually need to control the crosshair. Like you enter the sniper rifle stance, Alpha just sits there.
No, she directly points out on the enemy
at the start. Also, when you YRC, it also immediately goes on the top of the opponents, which is really cheap.
But the perfect reloads are more like the part where the player really needs to be good, because like there's a specific timing.
Yeah, specific timing. But it's not that
it's
hard.
It's not hard, that hard, but you need to be cool and collect it. You cannot just smash it.
Yep.
And that's something many other players have a hard time not mashing their buttons.
That's true.
Because
get Spineberry out.
Unfortunately,
no knockdown.
Oh, no stance.
Okay, there's the rifle that you're talking about.
Grenade head gets in, uses it.
Oh, 6-H danger time, okay. Both characters are probably really scary in danger time.
Yeah, just one hit, confirm it.
Yep.
Okay. Nice.
Ah, that was not a good entry.
Yeah, full conversion. Oh, drops.
Yep, no knockdown. Yep, just press it. S. Anytime, any day.
Yep, it's just. There's rarely any situation where pressing S is not a good.
Backstab option. Also being safe. Plus on block. If you want to press a button afterwards, you need to instant block. Okay. Otherwise. Not
and Alphalt has no, like, real 6P, so...
Yep. Oh, and he just
Should have thrown the grenade. Grenade, make it burst.
Yeah.
Make it
just
DP safe.
Back dash, low toss. That's a classic. He blocks backstab. Actually, he was able to 5K out this time.
It's...
Yep, a follower gets hit by it. Also, I believe this is actually the first time Ekusu is playing against any Axel.
He just sits there, blocks, and shotty.
And about 20% of chip damage gone.
And repeat. No repeat. Okay. Why?
He decided that he would be too cheap for that.
He decided it's lame, so...
Yes.
Nah, no hitting. No standing combo.
Counter to age. Yeah,
that's
Ransom
it.
Ransom YRC. This should be actually be it, yes. Block 6-H. Block 6-H.
Just do a ship damage move.
Yeah, like Ransom. Like Ransom.
Like Ransom.
Okay, so right now it seems like Meffy will be playing. I'm interested to see whether he's going to play Batman or Raven.
I'm also really interested. But I saw them both play at each other.
How did that go? Do you know?
It looked even.
Okay.
It looked even. I mean, for Raven it's pretty specific, right? And for Axel also, because they're like somewhat like projectile, full range based characters, right? So, but as far as I noticed, they both really understood that aspect.
Yeah, but I'm pretty sure that Raven has problems in the matchup. Simply because of the movement.
Yeah, his movement is very...
predictable.
Like, predictable, that's...
Yes, like... And I think that 5P of Axel is able to take care of both the air dash and actually the normal dash.
It stops the air dash, definitely.
But a lot of characters can actually run under Axel's 5P.
In this case, Raven can always use his, like, his teleport and bull forward backdash to just get through stuff. And but you will see he will throw the gebrechlich Licht, like the small projectile, and it will clash with Rens and nothing will happen.
Okay.
Full screen.
Okay, inhibits the movement with dart. Jumps out. Oh, actually, this is magic.
And this was really important. You can really the folks get this excitement gauge full.
Yes,
and then
this is definitely a game changer.
And
okay, gets the command grab.
There was no need. He had the meter for the combo.
Yep.
Version. Put it out. Ransom through it.
Yep. Just Ransom. Just do it. Just Ransom.
Kimochi. Full excitement.
Oh, so much great damage. So much great damage. Okay, Raven. I think Raven can kill off of one hit very easily now.
Yeah, sure.
Since his masochist gauge is full.
Not a random projectile, but anything else. Yes.
Yep. Oh, try
to command grab there.
Yep, but got hit by Ransom. Good jump, S.
Doesn't go for the follow-up. Oh, Kimochi.
Kimochi.
I could have pressed the button there.
Yep.
And reverse the button.
And since level 3, we're seeing the full animation.
No, show it, the full. 50 hits.
Well, actually 52. Oh, yeah, 50 hits in the cutscene. Yeah, you're right.
50 hit super. Also, nee, lass lieber. Egal.
Okay, glides in.
Okay,
JD knockdown.
Tricky Ogi projector. Again, low.
Yep. Calls it. Just empty sweep.
Oh.
Very nice up bar right there.
Yeah.
With far slash.
Good decision.
Into Ransom.
That's the weakness of the protector. Long startup. Dropkick, not good decision. And.
Very nice end, yes.
Yeah,
Charge chasing him out of the air very well.
And that's it.
Yep, this should be it. Wise man once said. Ba ba da da ba da ba da da.
Yeah, clean. Let your mother do the cleaning, bitch.
Very wise.
Okay, full combo.
Okay, he goes high this time. Get sweep knockdown.
Okay.
Okay, he's going to loop back again.
Extends.
Okay. Gets JD knockdown. He goes high.
And no combo.
Okay, keeps the pressure going.
That's blocked.
Yep, blocks the overhead.
Okay, back full screen. Like maybe just decided. Oh, I don't want to continue anymore. Back off. Good decision overall.
Okay.
No meter
right now. Meffy taking care of the neutral game really well. Just running away, being real evasive. Good play.
Yeah. Oh, almost got the confirm. And that's a true combo. It doesn't look like this, but it's a true block string. It looks so slow, but like
it's insane. It's insane. It really is.
Yeah, again with like jump high.
Okay, gets it out of the air yet again using a check trap 5P.
FD block, man. FD block when you recover.
You've got to. Got to.
Okay, this is going to be close, very close. Okay.
Oh, very awkward situation. Both players just not doing anything. Like the standard mix-up, double nothing.
Oh, that's not enough. He timeout went.
Charge, you just went in. Okay, nicely played by the two players.
Yeah, Miffy screwed up at the end.
Yes.
Oh, well, he really wanted to play the zone out game, not go in anymore because he had the life lead and that,
And that actually killed him.
That actually killed him because he got too defensive. Because before he was like backward forward, and then he just went backward, and that's what killed him actually. But I can understand why he did it. It was like okay, but just didn't work out.
Yeah, definitely. Please excuse me for a second.
Okay. So now we have Denza Berat against Chachi. I know against Axel. And let's see how this looks out. I don't know how much experience Berat has against Axel's. Because Aino has like this hover dash, right? And the hover dash really gets stuffed by things like 5P.
Oh, Fish, what's up?
Yo, what's up?
What's up?
Dracula, my boy.
Yeah, Team White Boys.
From Team White, right?
I'm Team White Boys,
Team Racist.
Team Racist.
Team Racist. Not as good as, or let's say not as good as Team Red Team.
Mm-hmm. We will see. Right now, Shaji is doing a great job.
Yeah. But we have everything. You don't know. We have the secret weapon everywhere.
Yeah, everywhere. Like, we're right next to me, right? You're talking about yourself all the time.
Ah,
right?
No, I'm free.
No, it's okay.
I'm free.
So next up we have Eno versus Axel.
Yeah, get stuffed, Hoverdash.
Yeah,
get stuffed. Let's see how Berat will play.
Yeah, he has to be cautious. Like,
did they play each other before, you know?
Mm-hmm. They played each other. But to be honest, like, on paper, it's even, I guess. If Eno can bait his TP and gets him in the corner, Axel's pretty much done. But in mid-screen, I think Axel has the advantage over Eno.
Yeah, because that's his game, right?
Yeah, it's his game. The screen is his game.
Yeah, I mean, and Eno's game is like knocking you down once
And fucking you up.
And then fucking you up, good. And I think they both can do that in this matchup.
Yeah.
What they are supposed to do. And Chachi just did exactly what he was supposed to do. He didn't let him get in once.
Yeah. But he did a good job. But right now, maybe we have a reverse game. Yeah. Oh,
just
what
like
I
this.
Said. Yeah. Safe jump for the DP. And everything looks bad for Axel right now. It's like one thing. But
reverse from this first round, now it's like...
Yeah. It's like one thing, and everything can fuck up for Axel.
Okay, now.
Okay, but it ain't over. Chachi already showed us that he can return the match, but not this time.
Like I said, one knockdown.
Yeah, one knockdown and da 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 da. And everything's done. Okay, nice, overhead. Oh, that was even a combo after that. That's nice.
Yeah, on crouching it, you can double.
Yeah, crouching or
counter
it, yes. But on counter, it bounces.
Yeah, on counter, it's like, oh, I can do any combo.
Yeah. All right, now, Sensa doing a great job of cornering Axel.
Overhead to overhead reset.
Yeah.
Classic. All right, good decision overall. Just now it's really anybody's game.
Yeah. But Sensei has no meter and he gets out of the corner, but I think that's a bad decision in my opinion. Because that right now it's more for Axel. And like Renson.
Okay, no, it can happen anything.
No, okay.
I got it.
One low and Sensei gets it.
Unreactable mix-up. Yeah. It's just fuzzy that thing. Fuzzy it.
Yeah.
So that you have luck and then yeah, hope for the best.
Yep. So next up is Josh. I heard he had some mix-up appearance at with Eno. As far as I know, we have Eno player down there in Munich.
Yeah.
Okay. I don't know who exactly, but
I've
someone
never heard of it.
Plays Eno, and he was like, "I know the matchup."
Let's see.
That's why Lunatic Soul was so decent against who was it again? Cesarin?
Matzer. Was the Eno player?
Matz, yes.
Matzer or Matz? Matzer.
Sorry, I don't know everyone. Like 80% of the people here, but there are some new faces always.
We have talked about this before. We don't know the games and the names. It's okay.
Mm.
I played him against Tools. He was okay.
You mean Josh? Yeah, he's decent. He plays pretty basic Kai, but I think that's an advantage of Kai. It's not a character where you can go crazy with. You have to control the space.
You don't just to play correctly.
Yeah.
Just make solid decisions. And don't greed saver too much.
Yeah. If it's getting too obvious, it's going to fuck you up.
Just don't be a scrub.
Yeah. Don't be a scrub, yes. That's
that's the
number
that's
one
the
rule in Guilty Gear.
And it puts for Kai the most.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
He's the most character here. Just play off legit.
Yeah.
Ah! New mechanics!
Nobody. But to be honest, we have a greed saver. Nice one. Nice.
Okay, misses just his rolls anyways.
Okay
forces out.
Interesting burst, but right now...
Extends. Doesn't go for the ground down, knockdown, or doesn't go for anything kind of...
Yeah, it was kind of a missed opportunity. He should have done
the... He can shoot, I'm going to get a knockdown. Knockdown. Or he gets an air DP
check, yeah.
But he didn't get it either. Okay, nice now. It doesn't full combo.
It will doesn't kill. Doesn't kill, but it's still a good option for.
Went for the double. Went for the for the safe jump without the normal. Then again another double dash, but he tried to press something.
Yeah.
And the projector covered anyways.
Mm.
I know.
Yeah. Pretty good wordplay, man. So, again, I know doing.
Reset.
That's a pretty dirty reset. It's
if you don't know it,
yeah, it's always after the launch. She does like in the air dash. It's the only mix up in mid screen. In the corner, she can do like the obvious PP and command grab, but like in mid screen, it's the most dirty setup she has.
Yeah, just don't tech mesh as soon as you see that that he's doing the
combo. As soon as she launches you and does the instant air dash.
But yeah. When you're not really lucid, you're just in typical menu. You're just smash, because that's what you're supposed to do.
So next up is smash.
Adult Benis. Yeah, Benis.
The meme lord.
He gets the poncho. The poncho does like 80% of all the work.
Yeah. He does all the magic.
No, not the poncho. He gets only the head.
Oh.
The head.
So half of the strength of a Czech Republic.
Yeah, that's bad. He gets a disadvantage.
But isn't PRK and Team Red?
PRK is a Team Red, yes.
Yes. So enemy support. So Sensei checking out either his music or his notes. Like, what do I do with
him?
The same side like with every character.
Now he's checking his waifus.
His waifus.
Hey, he's checking his note, like nobody can block Aino.
But it should be a... I don't know. How's the matchup versus Venom? What do you think of it?
It's pretty exotic.
Exotic,
so
right.
You rarely see it.
Mm.
I mean, Venom has struggles everywhere, so I would assume he also struggles there.
Yeah.
I mean, it's again, one knockdown. He has no good defensive options.
Yeah.
He knows how he's going to play. I mean, you can imagine that the balls can be placed in a good way that they stuff Aino's approach, but then again, she has a note.
Yeah.
And...
especially
I can't imagine that Venom has an easy time. Well, no. In which matchup does Venom has an easy time?
Yeah.
None. head set down bode well.
So... Players still getting prepared, taking a long time.
Yeah.
Nice!
Fist bump,
and then let's go.
I don't know. Maybe it boils down to the thing how good his 6P is.
Yeah, definitely.
Like, Venom has a pretty good 6P in my opinion, but I'm not so well known on the hitbox and the how fast it is. I think it's pretty fast, and that's good. Mm.
The thing is, how good is Sensor with a Venom hitbox? Because like it's really, really, really,
yeah, it's
really,
weird.
Really wonky.
It's weird.
It's so thin really wonky too, right? Because I play like Chip and...
With thin it's okay, but it's I know it's weird.
Yeah.
I know it's weird for other characters.
Mm. Okay. Time to block.
Doesn't combo?
Huh?
Oh, anyways, goes for corner mix up. Drops the combo.
Yeah.
Maybe. Forces the GLRC and grab. Oh, jumps out.
Yep.
His anti-air failed.
Yeah.
It's too strong. Jump enormous.
Yeah. It and seems that Arjun's Banus isn't comfortable yet. Maybe he will adapt.
I mean, I would really question what button do you press if you are in pressure of, well, I know, as a Venom player.
I don't know. Maybe P. But yeah, it's like, I don't even know how his hitboxes are.
You even struggle at this point that you don't really have the good normal you could press.
Yeah. Okay, now we pressure him. Nice.
No combo.
What does he do? Why a yellow C dash on? Okay, nice. Let's go. Balls to the walls.
Don't respect him so much.
Yeah.
He has no DP.
Let's go.
Balls, baby.
Put some...
Just with the tip.
Yeah. Okay, so one more mix-up for Sensor.
And in the corner. Drops it. Saves it.
Okay. Nice. Okay, let's go. Nice.
Full combo. Overhead.
Maybe Adam Bennis can turn this around. Yeah. Nice. Okay, long combo.
Full combo. Corner.
Nice. Okay. Setups.
Full setup. Burst. You should have baited there.
Yeah. Not dead yet. And with a dive. Taking it.
YOLO dive. Yeah, but chipped. Was it even hit? It was hit, but it would have chipped killed anyways.
Yeah.
It was a QV. He did full mid-screen QV.
Mm.
Which is also strange, but yeah, okay.
Yeah. Really.
So we at even now, right?
Like, yeah, again, it's 10-10.
10-10. Every advantage gets destroyed by some player.
It's even. It's really, really even. Especially in the later matches. I'm really excited how the other players are going to play. Because we have, like, at the gates, Mick and Kungster. But we have the tournament winner on the other side. And we have
You're fucked. And you know it. You're fucked and
You're already relying on one player. Everyone else is shit.
Yeah, that's enough.
At you all the time.
I had the idea just sent... We rename the team.
Yeah.
We rename the team. We are sending Rasta first. There was once a
we
team.
Only need Rasta.
Something along this line.
Rasta
like,
fever. Or
send Rasta first.
Yeah.
But now it's Antic.
Pretty solid soul, in my opinion. Maybe not on the same level like Candeep or Antnav, but
it's really hard to tell which soul is better than the other. Really,
I'd
like to see Pup have a hard time like. Seeing what makes a good soul or better soul.
Mm. Oh, he's denying the fist bump. Already sold.
No respect.
No respect.
Bad guy. Outlaw. Ground wiper at start.
Ground wiper.
would be against Aino, but
let's do it.
Do it.
No backdash, man. Okay, nice block of the low. Everybody gets it.
Oh,
and we told already about the mix up.
Don't mesh tech after the first two, three hits.
Yeah. So it starts. Three dives.
Oh, drops
it,
the Ogi.
Yeah, you try to reset him. And
this time doesn't work. I mean, you can punish it, but you're really good. You need to delay tech, and then you can throw her on her with. But that's really like, really need to be good to do, to be able to pull that off.
Yeah. Okay. Again, he knows, he doesn't know the setup. So every time...
as long as it works, do it.
Yeah, just do it. So, Antic doesn't know the matchup, getting destroyed right now. Okay, was it on purpose?
With the normal dust.
Oh, 5k, maybe the return of a king. Oh, not yet.
You know,
it doesn't look so bad.
Oh, it's okay. No dip.
Oh! Hey,
nice.
Hey.
Could be dizzy. Then go for the Fafnir combo. I mean, with Aino, it's really like, even if you have not such a like a stun combo character, you can get the stun pretty easy as soon as you hit like two combos in a row. And with and Soul, it's the same.
Nein, wirklich.
So it's next for Team Retto. Team Retto against Team Waito. And now comes Sinnoh for Shino. With all the O's.
Shino, yeah.
Huh? Yeah. Sin. Shino, Sin. And Senza played a lot against me.
Yeah.
So he knows what Sin can do. Shino will have a hard time, let's say. Because, like, Sin's 6P is shit against Aino. His DP is also useless because safe jump, right? Of course.
Yeah.
But he can make it safe. That's
a
plus.
Yeah, slide, right?
But since wake up timings are awkward, maybe you don't get the reversal really, and then you fuck cross the drop. And let's see.
Especially because both players know each other.
Yeah.
Played some matches against.
But two combos is stun. You actually need three combos, but you only need two because in the second you get the stun.
Yeah.
Assuming you get a decently good combo, not like slight driver, that's not enough.
Mm. So, setup time. Okay.
Yeah, good programming. Account system, well made.
Thank you, Sony.
Thank you, Sony, for making this awesome.
Yeah. For making it more complicated like it was before.
Operating system.
Yeah.
But thanks hiding me from my PS3 fans.
Yeah.
Thanks for not being able to invite friends into my game. Thanks for everything. Thanks for PS Plus. For playing online,
yes. But let's return to the match and stop assault. Because we cannot change it.
Full intro, swag.
Swag, swag.
Look at the eye.
Eye of a tiger. The only eye. So, let's see how Shino adapts to this matchup. I think it's 50-50, right?
It's
what
really a one-shot thing, right?
Yeah.
Sin has just the damage. It's just the damage, yeah?
Yeah.
Get the damage and I know it's wrecked.
Yeah.
But if you really control the node pretty good, and Zenza can do that, you have to really like...
You have to play patient, right?
You have to play patient and you have to play smart.
Mm.
Like really react to things that are happening. Ah, this was smart.
Versus,
like run up.
Yeah. Because one thing...
grab.
One thing player don't know that Aino can control the node. So it's not always the same arc.
No, I mean, the big thing is against Sin, control the node so that it hits like slide. That slide doesn't go profile the node.
Because you can slide under it, right?
Yeah, if you just do it like regularly in a...
Nice.
Come on, do some fucking... Yeah,
Instant overhead.
Very good.
Very good. Shino does exactly what he needs to do. But now, I take everything back.
Senza don't drop.
Yeah. Oh!
This is also the Senza really knows that when you DP slide, there's a hole you can throw.
Yeah?
Yeah.
It just I beat it beforehand, so
you don't need him to IB the DP.
Yeah?
You just need
not
to
even?
Block it.
Oh,
it's not a true combo, as long as you're not hit.
Ah, okay.
Or counter hit or like crouching.
Crouching. Oh, okay, that's good.
So as long as you block, throw mesh.
Yeah. Oh. And full big combo. Damage.
Goes for the safe jump, doesn't hit the safe jump. Unfortunately.
Oh.
That's the other option, that is a true combo, right? DP driver.
Big leap driver.
But that's like, you don't get a knockdown out of it, you cannot eat afterward, you still need to slide, and that costs like a lot of food.
Mm. And it's pretty risky, right?
It's not, no, it's more safe than the other version, but yeah? It costs much more food. That's the
ah,
problem.
Okay.
Because
that's
when you DP, and you have, you cannot do it when you have no, not almost full food.
Yeah.
That's the problem. Alright, eats. Full bush. It's not so good. I mean, in this matchup, Sin needs to chase, because when I know it's full screen, she always can like note, and then you can just if you need, if you block the note, that's bad.
Oh.
Okay.
Oh, we set up for Super. Oh, nice high low. Good block from Sensor.
And
he's taking it. Nice one.
Damage.
So 11
to
11.
I'm really surprised
again.
That this is just happened, right?
It just happened.
Combo
right.
Damage. Combo. Yeah. So.
And that's it.
Dead. Really surprising.
That's the life of a Sin.
They're more life, yeah, more life of I know, right?
I know, yeah.
More life of I know.
Getting wrecked.
I mean, for Sin, you just press, oh, he's dead, okay.
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 What happened today?
Eat. Oh my.
Yeah.
And finished.
So next up, we have M, aka Zuckerfee, in the Hard Edge forums. Playing maybe Faust or maybe John.
Yeah, Faust. He should pick Faust in my opinion. Because like Faust is... I mean, Sin really needs to think about what he's doing against Faust.
Mm.
I mean, there are some matchups where he can just make his pressure strings like, oh, they're not ending and da-da-da. And with Faust, Faust has really good normals and he can really stuff a lot of things. If he,
okay.
It's the other way around. Faust can press a lot of buttons and in the decision that, like, the scramble situation,
yeah,
Faust will win. Because, like, his... Ich quit.
Where and yeah,
like, Faust can really... Basically, Sin cannot jump against Faust.
Okay.
That's a big thing.
Mm. Yeah.
If the Faust does it right.
Mm. Oh.
And he can also not eat really good. But if the Faust does it right.
Yeah.
Assuming. And now Shino is pretty much bad situation. No food. Against Faust. Really bad.
But he kind of says it.
Yep. Let him.
Let him eat. Oh. Didn't respect your bomb, getting blown up by it.
Oh, didn't cancel.
Yep. Eating? Okay.
Okay, even.
Oh.
Full combo?
Not yet.
Nani Karin Kana. Now, right, this, like the slide.
Oh, what the fuck?
And the wacky overhead resets.
Yeah.
It's this overhead, man, this overhead. Goes for the meat, simple meaty. Oh, nice confirm.
Yeah.
Nice confirm.
Oh, nice.
Each could have punished each hop very easy.
Put on there.
So now, loads. Yeah, like this. Unfortunately. Got hit.
Oh.
Ah, not a bad decision.
Oh, and good to be by Sen Shino.
Just at the right.
To say fish, but you're not playing yet. Oh, okay. Weird start by Shino with a DP. Can he get something out of this? If he starts with a DP?
No.
No. Right?
Actually, nothing.
Nothing. No, so it was a little bit too YOLO. Okay.
Side dust combo is not known.
Yeah.
Hammers. Oh, close to dizzy.
Very close. Oh, nice. Best bait. Chino now in a good
position. Anti-air boy. He really should.
Nein.
This could be.
It's a. Okay. Ay.
Philip or Johnny?
Johnny, bist du? Okay.
Johnny getting in and neft. Soul against Faust also. Faust also really good against Soul.
Yeah.
Let's see how cool and neft is going to stay.
Yeah.
And getting in.
You know, he has already a player like Lichi, who we already practiced against. But let's see if he's patient enough. Because, like, patience is a very big thing against Souls, I guess.
Yeah, really big.
Because, like, the items, you have to look at the items, you have to look at his positioning. Sometimes you have to look if he has, like, mini fouls.
And then you have to adjust to random items, right? You have to think, oh, go now this item, what do I do correctly? And do I block? Can I punish? And
definitely. Like,
that's really. And smart guy. Soul smart guy, you need to be. And I think Soul also needs to be extremely good, like 6P.
6P.
6P. I mean, he needs to beat so many normals with his 6P. And when you press 6P, right, you really need to know when Faust is going to press something.
Yeah.
If it counter hits, good.
Yeah, definitely.
And against like 6Ps, Faust cannot really do much, right?
Mm.
He can just like 2P, 2P is shit.
He gets nothing out of it.
2P is shit.
Yeah.
And 2K is not really like a neutral move. It's more
it's OB. Yes.
It's OB.
And anti-air in some cases. Like
And anti-air, of course, anti-air and OB. But not like on a ground neutral basis.
Yeah.
So all he really has is like 2H.
2H, yes. And he has to cancel it every time because it's unsafe as fuck. Block. But let's return to the match. Right now, both pretty much respecting. But
risky burst, but worked out.
But buddy, both of the players already don't have any burst. Oh, okay.
Could have short tap.
And nerf.
Meteors.
Both are at a very, really far away. But now they're getting it. Nice going away. Oh, getting the black hole. Let's see what M does it out of it. Oh, nice blocks by the way. Okay, respect it. Good, didn't get blown up by the bomb. Okay, right some. Good 6P.
Yeah, good 6P.
Yeah, I think Faust has...
Faust has ridiculous 6P.
Yeah. Especially after the situation against the right storm. Because with some characters, it's really hard to anti-air.
Okay, DP, unfortunately, no counter.
Yeah. But the Nerf doing a great job. If he doesn't tilt and doesn't do anything stupid,
anybody's
he could win.
Round, really, at this point. Just stay cool.
What?
Oh, the drop. Nice.
2D.
And the Nerf.
I thought it would combo, but it didn't.
Yeah.
But good decision from Lichi, but he got hit by a Nerf afterwards. Yeah. Nice rope. With life kick.
Mm-hmm. Your DP getting out of pressure.
Yeah, he was plus. I mean, you could expect that he was going to press something.
Yeah.
And bam.
Again. It
meteors at the right time again. Again, always these meteors just at the end of the round.
Yeah.
It's always so painful to see this. Poor guys who play against Faust at this point.
Doesn't look that bad. But then
chip.
FD. So, sorry guys, I have to go next up. Now, you soon, man.
I'll see you. Have fun playing against M. Zuckerface. Fausto. Character lock, Mick? I believe nobody cares about character lock. As soon as we saw Raven, nobody cared really. And we are going to have a Heyun or Kum, or how, what part of the name is supposed to be used from Kandeep at some point. So I think Grammas will join me now. Yes, he will go sit down. Hello. Hello. Greetings.
Hello. Mm-hmm. So we have Dracula against M. Who's Dracula playing?
I'm not sure. I assume Johnny. Yeah, you pick Johnny. So you know anything about this matchup?
No.
No?
I think it's Johnny is in Johnny's favor, like all the matchup in the game.
That's pretty universal statement, right? Johnny matchup favor. But I think like Faust can challenge him on all the similar range. It's just that Faust doesn't get like the bullshit damage out of the random hits. Yeah. That's the thing. And let's see how good Dracula knows how to like play the poking game. I can't really imagine that he will stuff the drill and then get massive damage out of it.
If round start to drill. No. Oh, sitting on the bomb. Oh, got kind of.
Yeah, already. And he got the and it starts. Goes for.
Oh. Kokizeme was air dash.
Oh,
he tried dust, really?
I think he tried two dust. Two dust would have been. Like, sweep would have been the best. Nice. Out of the startup of the.
Meteors.
Just doesn't want to take. It should have. The meteors were on the other side.
Should have blocked. Oh, nice 6P counter.
Yeah, you shouldn't jump or air dash against Faust. That's like not so good. Okay, base baits nothing because he has no burst.
Oh, nice low bleeds. Oh, gets
the full charge. Very good.
Scalp. Oh, try to wire throw maybe.
Yeah, but odd ankle. This move. Good, no coins anymore. Goes for the grab.
Oh, grab. Standard combo. And we could have RC into unblockable maybe. Oh, another combo.
No, he has no points. It's not useful anymore. Unblockable now.
Why? I don't know why he did charge the blitz. He had no meter to blitz back. What? I guess possible drill. For a swift, some whiffs.
At tips everywhere, tips.
Scald.
Anybody's game.
Oh, bomb.
Just block it.
He just blocked the bomb. 7 seconds.
He will timeout. He will play a timeout.
Yeah. Why is not...
He doesn't know this.
I don't know why... Yeah.
Correct decision.
Still Johnny pressure, using a lot of coins. Just to pressure.
Back full screen. Not so good. Oh, gets the one hit.
Can convert?
Oh,
no,
wow. He tried to conversion, but
gold bar swift.
Okay, level 2.
Some sloppy plays here. Try the charge bar, get punished. Drop the combo.
Drops the combo. Okay, Zweihander YRC. Good, but whiffed.
Oh, unblockable. Yes. No?
Yeah, he didn't confirm.
Oh, he didn't block.
Unblockable overheads. Stuffed overhead and startup.
Yeah. Oh, he bait bars but didn't punish. Oh, he could have convert from the bomb bag. Ah, didn't block low. He went for a throw maybe. No coins anymore. Miss final.
Just one hit.
It's close.
Ah.
Oof. Drill is
not okay.
Yeah.
And then and, win. But he still takes it. Nicely done. So, team. White, we are down one guy. Let's see, who's next.
So who's they gonna send?
Which time are you?
Send?
Which
Team Red.
Your Team Red, alright. So, again, both.
I have to play, okay.
And then your Team White? Grandma's is not Team Red, he's Team White. It's Team White! I'm stupid. Oh, I'm stupid. Yeah. Red, white, blue, black. Yeah, sure. Sorry. Colors are hard. I'm colorblind. Yeah, that's true. I'm colorblind. That's my excuse. So yeah, Italian grandmas who's on every tournament basically in existence in Europe for Team Red. Johnny against Soul. Let's see if he knows the matchup. I think Soul has the tools to deal with Johnny. And Johnny has Johnny's stuff. 2D should be actually pretty good. But Johnny can stuff 2D, of course, with 2S. Which is also pretty good. Coin starter? No coin starter. Backdash coin. Oh, could have done more there. Okay, fuzzy jump out, jump peep. Yeah, Gamas goes for like, let's say easy to, hard to punish Soul, instant air dash stuff. Oh, dash up 5k and stroke. Nice.
Very
good. Unfortunately, doesn't get the mid screen knockdown. Ah, oh, and 200 jump throw. Gives up his missed final charge. Doesn't care. Still has almost all the coins. Ah, drops the combo. Ah, when six heavy whiffs like this, you should always like press something else. But Johnny, it's like so long recovery without the missed final cancel. No mid screen combo after that, after K missed final. Yep, again just ERD jump, heavy slash, and if it gets blocked, just make it safe. Or Soul again. he tried the dive kick and wrong positioning other side. Gets the instant air dash combo, unfortunately drops the easy part. He could play timeout now. I think he should. Yeah, just do a string and that's also timeout. Oh, too bad. Really, really close. Yeah, classic wild throw, nothing to see here. Ah, drops it. Went for the optimize. Unfortunately, dropped it at the part where you're supposed to drop if you don't do it right. Oh, Scandinavian burst. Unfortunately, drops the punish, the free combo. Nice 6P. And that's it. Odd decision, neutral jump. Jump H. Anyways, game gets up. Went on. Nice confirm. Basic soul combo. Ah, unfortunately, drops the knockdown kick. Nope, confirms the dive kick. Nice. This was really nice. Micro dash and air dash combos. Nice bait from the DP. Unfortunately, didn't punish, but it's hard to do. Anybody's game. Dracula will get the burst. Yeah, now he has it. Golden burst. Didn't really see much supers. Like burst supers so far. Oh, gets the poke out. Very solid play. Solid play overall. A little too much IRD for my taste, but was good overall. So next is going to be... Was? Ich hab nicht drauf geachtet. Egal. Plaga gets back on to his teammate on the bench. And Gramas awaits his next prey. Who is it going to be? We are pretty much down to the last guy, so the next players will be the best of the best. PRK, maybe? Maybe the ATG? So who's still going next for you?
Shoutouts to my mom.
Shoutouts to PRK's mom. Thanks for raising PRK in the way you have done. Our team White is shaken. They don't know what to do. They're just so scared. They think there's always going to be a TP.
So after two matches, I'm back. Hi. What's up?
How did that match feel?
It was pretty even. I did a lot of mistakes. I let him get away with a lot of stuff. But burst bait was nice from him, like after the right storm. Or I don't know what exactly it was. But I could have won.
I don't know what Johnny can do against like instant air dash, jump age, most likely
nothing.
You have to air throw.
Maybe if he's in a really good position, you can high miss the final.
Yeah, but most of the time you have to respect it.
Yeah, especially after the tech in the corner.
But it was pretty close, yeah, anybody's game really.
It was the first time against him anyway, so it was pretty okay for
with Johnny.
Yeah.
I mean, Johnny's new character.
Yeah.
The bullshit is not even fully unleashed.
Yeah. Not yet.
Not yet. But there are enough guys who play him already, so at some point
someone
will pull it off. Most likely.
I can do his stuff, but you have to play Nurtry first to get to that stuff.
Yeah. I mean, he's hard. You cannot ignore that. He's not easy to learn.
Yeah, definitely not. It seems easy at first, but
no, it's not. As soon as you did try to go for one mid-screen like knockdown, you know it's not.
Yeah. It depends on the character. Like Soul is okay.
Yeah. Already this makes him hard. Like the character specific aspect. Mm. Of everything.
I would say like
good.
I would say at least like 60% of the cast is okay. Nearly easy. But like the rest is really hard. Like Ram is like the hitbox out of hell. Johnny cannot do anything in the mid screen.
She goes so high, right?
Yeah,
she's so lightweight.
And she has a pretty small hitbox. Doesn't look like it because of her...
Yeah, I know it. I also drop stuff because of her crappy ass hitbox.
It looks bright because like she has the swords, but the swords are not the hitbox on her. So it's only that kind.
Oh, she's a tiny bitch. Yeah. Yeah.
So like the throw into a hard knockdown is possible. So you have to do coins. Coin combos.
So now Zuf, South?
Zuf from France.
For
Team Waito?
What does he play? I haven't seen him.
I haven't seen him either.
Oh, okay.
I didn't know that he exists. But now he's my teammate, so I have to cheer for him. So, technical problems. But, again. Okay. So.
Both have legacy.
Okay.
Them technical abilities. Yeah, it's like it supports legacy, but you need to have an account active. And
It's okay, but better than Sweetheart 5.
I read like the legacy support has now 8 frame delay, so it's the OP choice.
Really?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, they forgot to put it in there, so the legacy controllers don't have that lag.
Oh please, man, please.
Good decisions.
Yeah.
Good decisions everywhere.
Everywhere. So, the classic, Kai versus Soul. I didn't see his Kai yet.
The matchup overall, it's always said like it's even until Kai gets hit.
Yeah. It's like a certain rule in Guilty, right? After that, you see who's fraud, who isn't. But we have Evil Kai on the left with Zuf, on the right side, we've got us with Soul still.
So. No FD jump outs. Tried to disrespect, gets blown up for, but Grammas drops the combo, gets put in the corner. 2D, that button. Good burst.
Yeah, most good addition. You already saw that he was in the chart bandit bringer. So
don't double jump too much. You're Kai, you want to stay on the ground. And yeah, Grammas takes that pretty convincingly.
Really convincingly, yeah.
jump heavy. Yeah. Heavy. Tried to go for the instant air dash combo, didn't get it right.
Good instant block, but he didn't block low. Now it's time for Kai to shine. Projectile. Okay.
Corner blender. Good decision.
Oh,
on the last active frames.
Yeah. And
confirm. Oh, nice confirm.
Yeah, nice confirm. But I don't know why he didn't do the DP knockdown. Like every Kai tries to do the air combo, but after it, Kai doesn't have any advantage.
Yeah, you have always.
You always commit.
It's always the decision. Do I want to get the damage or do I want to get the knockdown? Yeah. It's always like this. People tend to go for damage, but they shouldn't really. Especially in the case with Kai, where he has such good Ogi.
Yeah.
Like, Ogi, you just have to block, right?
Mm. Especially if you have an opponent with low life in the corner. I would go for the safe setup.
I think it really depends also on the type of character you play, right?
Yeah.
If you have a character where it's always you need to chase and he always runs away, you really, really want to get that knockdown.
Yeah.
For example, against Faust. Kai gets Faust as Kai, you always want to get that knockdown.
So, Zoof. That was fast. Was a good performance in the second round, but make one mistake and let Grammas breathe and he took it.
Just one life, right?
Yeah, one life.
Sorry.
So it's pretty hard to adapt anyways, but Grammas does his best right now.
Yeah. So now is coming up the Soul Mirror. Classic. I think both have beaten each other.
Let's see.
Okay, so next up, we have a new character again.
I totally forgot that Candy plays Kum now.
Yeah.
The Kum.
Yeah. The time has come.
I think the Japanese call her like a second name, like the Heyun thing.
Heyun, yes.
Yeah. The local man.
The man. The wasabi man.
Candy, the local man, yes.
Yeah.
Who thinks things and says them.
Mm.
So yeah, let's see Kum. I haven't really seen anything. I played her a little, like I did a combo challenge and everything. And that felt really well, of course she's Link character, right?
Yeah.
And let's see what Candy can do.
Yeah.
She has funky Ogi as far as I saw.
Yeah.
Like strong Ogi.
It's okay.
If she gets to it.
Yeah.
Oh.
But.
Nice.
Don't have to underestimate Kum. Even though she's so big, she has pretty good mobility. So you have to be aware.
Her adage is like this. And she, like her direction control drop kick.
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
Reverse super.
Release it.
Yeah. Bam. Takes it.
Oh, he can do that full screen. Interesting.
Oh.
Yeah, Grammas doesn't know the matchup naturally, but he shouldn't really block like when the ball gets full screen to him. Like, just like the thing you don't want to do. It's like with a note almost, like just, I know. Oh. Ah, nice grab. Oh, bad.
Yep. 5H.
Unfortunately, cannot combo afterwards without anything else.
Yeah, but it's okay for the OK.
Odd trajectory, really like whoop.
Yeah, he can
totally
she can even control it.
Yeah, you can neutral, forward, backward.
Yeah.
That was interesting, really.
Yeah,
that's cool.
Really. especially after the 6-H contact. Okay. Let's go.
Free combos.
Dropped the third one. Good IB into the row, good punish. nice throw.
He saw it. Wow. I tried to burst bait there.
Bad burst by Grandma.
Nice done.
Candeep takes it. Nice one. Really good control with your character.
Yeah, that was really surprising. Really surprising. Man.
Yeah. Candeep already told me like he really feels comfortable with his character.
Yeah, so I mean, like, feeling comfortable is something, right?
Yeah. Especially if it's unknown.
Kurzfort ist der nächste. Kurzfort. Also, die Kurz versus Kurz.
So, next we have Wien Boys, Vienna. He's from Vienna, right?
He's from Vienna, yeah.
Yeah,
right. He's a Vienna player named Kurzfort. Pretty cool guy, by the way. Plays Venom. Let's see, I think. This one is still unknown. Let's see how it will play out.
Yeah, it's really specific, right?
I think
Venom can at least at this matchup.
That's okay.
Du kannst das Fehler VDV vielleicht noch hinzufügen. Also das Tag, aber so ist okay.
Let's see if Venom can like play his ball game in this matchup like more freely, right?
Mm. But if Kum is in the air, he should be prepared. He should at least try to anti-air. I don't know which buttons.
Yeah, well, how is this like the drop kick plus?
No, it's minus.
It's minus, okay.
Yeah. Or at least it should be at zero so far.
I have not seen really people like pressing buttons afterwards.
Yeah, I think it's so obvious you could press blitz shield.
Yeah,
similar like to the butt of. Pot or like with 2H from May. I think you have to deal it like that.
Oh, so charged but was not unblockable yet?
No, not yet. It takes a long time. But I think the more he charges it, the more plus it is after.
Yeah, at least it looks that way, right? Yeah. But to get it unblockable, it's like as weird as long charge.
Throw. Okay. I'll try to. Reset and do the overhead afterwards.
Candeep always waits a little moment to see if they press something after into the dive kick. So I assume it's minus.
Good, pretty good basics. Now he has to block. Got good
burst.
Now he has all the meter. Now he can party. But again, the Venom hitbox. Okay. That not RC. Candy with a really good showing right now.
But I think Venom could just outpoke him like better. Like
could be.
He has the normals, right?
I think he has the second biggest hitbox in the game. Besides
I just mean if he's standing there and charging on this distance, I think he could just Stinger, for example, or like his normal, like his fast slash.
Yeah.
Should but like the matchup knowledge, right? The advantage of the advantage of the unknown.
Yeah. He takes advantage of it.
So Thompson is now on, and Thompson is really like a really knowledgeable player.
Yeah.
I can imagine that he's really like knows like the logic.
Yeah,
what
he's
supposed to do is.
Yes. And especially like he plays Johnny.
Yeah, he plays Johnny.
So it isn't Kum cannot like jump as much as against him.
Yeah, like, you can stuff it with like this long edge. Long as normals.
Long as normals.
And
6P.
6P should be more good.
And sometimes just dash out of it. That's the one thing maybe players can do. He can like control his movement, but I think if he really is up in the air and you know you are pretty up close, especially like Johnny has a dash. Similar to Street Fighter. He has a hop.
Has a hop.
So it's like just dash once and after combo anti-air after him. Like dash under 5k coin or something. should be possible. But let's see if Thompson does it. So, let's begin.
I would imagine he can just miss Finder away the ball. Maybe he will notice.
Yeah. But let's begin. Good start with both of the players.
Run up. Blitz.
Blitz the coin. Was too far away to get the reject.
The dive kick really does its work.
Yeah. And really nice with the yellow C. Just to mess up the timing of the anti-air.
Full charge.
Yeah. Sometimes
should have gone just for normal follow up and get
that's pretty scrappy tactic so far. Because everyone is like, if I charge it through, maybe I get a hit and can do a full combo.
Full combo. Yeah, that's a temptation.
That's really really big temptation. But both of players doing a pretty good job.
Oh, it's okay.
Yeah.
Still, the dive kick is really like I tried 2-6-P too early.
Yeah. Nice overhead.
Not the right spacing for the bounce combos. Yeah.
That's one.
Dashes into the
projectile.
Oh.
Yeah, that's nice.
It's really nice, yeah. Really long. Out.
Doesn't use the meter. He was waiting for the burst, I think. But.
Showing that.
But he's
rage. That
he's
the
ready
fire for burning in the heart.
Yeah. He thinks he's ready. Yeah. Good two piece from Candy. He knows that. Johnny cannot dash in freely. It's like 16 frames. You have to react to that. Even with a button or you try to poke him beforehand. So he cannot get in. Oh, Thompson messing up the combo. Should have been a knockdown for him. But now he has to deal with the corner right now. Doing really great work with combo.
It's interesting. What he actually does, it's not much, it's just sweep into a like kick and that's it.
Sometimes this is enough. Oh, nice block by both.
Anti-air.
Yep.
Dive kick. Missed the yellow. See the correct one.
Good back dash.
Unfortunately gets.
Okay, let's go with a mix up. That's overhead. Oh, 6B. Oh, did we overhead a little bit too early? Okay, nice instant blocks.
Does this move like up point?
No, it hasn't, but it's unsafe as fuck. It's like, I don't know, Rayla talked to me and he said like, I heard it from Rayla that the move has minus 22 on block.
It's like, wave goes forward and like,
yeah.
This minus 20?
Yeah,
22, really?
Yes. But you see it's really fast.
It's fast, yeah.
I think it's like,
has the upper body involved?
I guess not, no. Oh. I think it's pretty fast.
I just saw it as a combo tool. But it's, it's fast.
Because you saw, like, beforehand, he just 6H. If opponent press something, he gets a floor slide as a contact and can do the projectile afterwards, so it's pretty free. But it's a commitment.
Yeah, of course. If it's minus 20, it's definitely a commitment. Yeah.
But Candy is realizing that and doesn't press it always. Always end it at the right time.
So. Now comes Sumpf Auge with the walking shotgun.
Walking shotgun. Especially now we are tied in the
again. This happened already 2-3 times.
Yeah.
That we get always tied up again. I don't think Alfred really cares about anything that Com does. Like just do the usual stuff. Just press slash, go into stance. And then do shit.
Yeah, do your shit.
Press that button. He just needs maybe to check shortly what's his weight, and then that's it.
Yeah.
Is he fat? He's fat. Like it's weight class. Like hard or like heavy or is hard? Is weight class for a combo? Is he like heavy? Like Potemkin?
Weight class.
No, the combo weight.
I think it should be heavy, but not as heavy as Pot, I guess.
No, nobody's heavy, but it's like similar. He looks like this.
Yeah.
Just shotgun S, do it.
Zum Vage, that's the right thing. Doesn't let play come.
So good, that's.
Hey. That's a shotgun loop. Pretty nice damage.
goes for the air reset. Not even for the green.
Oh, is this perfect? I don't know. Oh,
reversal. Grenade.
Yeah. And perfect punish by Sumpfauge. To 5H.
Shotgun did the work.
Yeah. Pretty much.
It's not even effort anymore, it's just a shotgun. Like, I know Sumpfauge, he always goes for the shotgun. And so, like, half the time he's in shotgun.
So,
That's pretty big. Yeah. Canadian burst!
German burst.
No, it was Scandinavian burst.
Scandinavian burst?
Yeah, because they're so high in North.
yes. I remember. We are in Europe. But Kendeep does a pretty good job. At first he was like, okay, I tried to play the same game like before. But he saw that he couldn't do that. And now he's trying to play a little bit more patient. Doesn't try to get in the corner. Tries to zone fireballs. Nice trade.
Tries to profile the fireball, yeah. But like it was already out. No recovery at all.
Yeah. Oh, didn't punish that.
No, it was plus.
Was plus?
Yeah, plus, because like ground red. That's because it's Elfet, man. Long range, riderless plus on block.
I thought it was only applied to the air version.
No, it's also on the ground version.
What the fuck?
So the air version is such much more plus on block.
What the fuck, why? Good blocks by Candy. Oh, no profiles.
Have space properly, of course.
Oh, nice.
Gets again the counter hit.
For Oki.
Okay. I thought he totally missed his Oki, but it worked.
No, I think it was a purpose. It was
maybe
that one overhead, maybe a second one.
Oh, the edges. Yeah. Fast slash again.
Now he has to respect the corner. Especially like, now don't burst bad. Yeah, no. Oh, dead now. He has to be bad.
Oh.
Nice conversion.
I think he wanted to do 2D. Yeah. Now no, jumping deep. sniped!
Yep, mach mal. Mach mal hin jetzt.
Oh, ATG.
ATG at the scene. It's L, yeah.
At the gate door.
The gatekeeper, maybe.
Gatekeeper. One of the final gatekeepers for Team White.
Now we only have like Kungs and Nick in our team right now.
Yeah, shit.
Yeah, so we are pretty much at the end right now. I think in the other team we only have like Peter, PRK and Krusta, I guess. So it's gonna be really, really, really close. No?
Jinken!
Loco, man. Pretty good job, man.
Thank you.
Yeah,
pretty impressive overall with the new character. Yeah. Already
especially
winning
for
stuff.
Like week one, it's okay.
Let's say like day two.
Yeah, day two.
Day two, day three. I mean, he could not. He didn't have the time to play it really.
Yeah.
Because like the tournament was going on and the character itself was not in the main tournament.
Yeah.
So yeah, Chip against Elfet. If Elfet gets a knockdown,
Chip is dead.
It's bad. Really bad.
Yeah.
Even more bad than normally. Yeah. It's not three combos, it's two combos.
Yeah.
Let's see. But ATG has everything he needs. He can do it.
Yeah,
let's
good,
see it out.
Good basics, good reads. And he plays like Chip like for 10 years now.
I expect a lot of command grabs.
Yeah.
Like the leaf command grab.
Yeah, he should do that. Because sometimes he catches off guard. Oh, no.
That fucking got shotgun ass.
Yeah, he had to commit to the burst. Oh,
nice.
That was 2H. Now it's time to pressure Elfet. Okay.
Get the first sign of getting hit, burst.
No. No random alpha blades. Doesn't make any sense. That hurts, man, this
press, hurt. Press. Oh, that air is so good. If it's away, it's the best poke, it's close, it's like,
she always, like, pops.
Pop that champagne. Yeah. Oh, there it was.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, it didn't work.
Ah, But at the gates
was input?
No. I thought that Zumfogger was trying to anti-air because the timing was a little bit off. Because like Chip has two different
nice
command grabs out of
the again the command grab. Unfortunately, yeah. Not quite enough close to the corner.
But right now, at the gate's looking pretty good. But now he's in the corner again.
Everything can change in a moment's notice.
Yeah. Now he has to respect that shit. Okay, nice.
Harakiri. Okay, teleport, yes. Lows, yes.
But that was a... Normally it would be a really bad burst, but okay. Maybe Zumpkow...
If it works, it works.
Yeah. Gamma Blade,
and
nice.
Dead.
So, at the gate, with a pretty good adaption, not going too YOLO with Chip. Taking advantage of some stuff. Oh, but that... Just two hits, and it hurts so much.
Oh, and corner shotgun. Yeah. Drops the...
Nice.
Drop didn't the get the Mibi. Bursts to stay alive and keep him in the corner. Yeah. Unfortunately, does not... This could have been it.
Yeah.
If he would have confirmed the...
Fuck. That looks bad, but Alpha drops it too.
Shotgun.
Maybe Chip can get off the corner. Now it can begin. Hey.
Has nothing, corner pressure starts, blocks it.
Nice. Let's go.
Yeah, if it doesn't hit, it's not that Chip is in a disadvantage. Just doesn't hit.
Didn't block afterwards. Oh fuck, now it's
really
bad. Backdash.
Nice backdash.
No.
Oh, nice. That's it. If it doesn't drop. Nice.
Really good throw into RC.
Volatile. Effort's S is the worst S in the game.
Yeah.
Like, no S is better in every decision, in every situation. Like, if you press down, you press S. If you in the air, you press S. You can. It's
if
always
close,
good that
you press S.
If you're close, you press F. You're at shotgun, you press S. And sniper S is.
It's a universal button.
It's an S special.
Yeah.
It's the only universal button.
Yeah. Oh, I forgot. PRK is in our team, not in the red team. So everything is.
For all the Zato players.
Yeah.
Rigged.
So we still have hope. PRK looking happy right now. I don't know if he knows the L matchup.
I think he understands and knows.
He's a pretty smart player, in my opinion.
Yeah, he understands stuff, so that's why he knows. But still, I mean that you know does not really help.
Yeah, if you can't execute it.
Against corner mix-up from effort, I mean.
But,
it really boils down to the first thing that comes out of, do you have a button that can even challenge?
Yeah.
Like, basically, reload, shotgun, reload. Like the shotgun shot. Even like something cheap like this. Even if you instant block it, do you have a button that can challenge that?
Yeah.
Clean. Because when you trade, effort is always advantage.
Yeah.
And I don't think Zato has that.
No.
He doesn't.
But in reverse, Alpha doesn't have any good reverses either.
No.
So
yeah,
gets in the corner
that's her basic
pressure.
Idea, right? She has so much offensive but so little defense.
Yeah. So if she gets in the defense, you can. Nice one, Trident. Read that. Shout out to my Czech boys watching the stream. And everybody else. I hope that some Polish players are watching. Because we miss you guys.
Oh,
really bummer that you didn't.
Yeah, PRK does the dirty tech. He picked the eclipse color where you don't see shit.
Okay.
Dirty Shaq techniques. The poncho and the hat is not enough.
Yeah. Now the dirty colors. Okay, so round begin.
Get sniped.
Yeah. Zumfogger was a pretty good start at the beginning.
And he is away. Oh, get in, boy.
Pretty good block. Oh.
Yeah, he could have done the unblockable. I think he wanted to do the unblockable shot, but that's too early. Slash doing its work. Yeah, you know.
Oh, Shadow Galley, nice. Hitting him in the corner. Now it's time.
Just doesn't want to take it first.
Yeah, just
and I think also PRK will burst at the best possible incoming moment.
Yeah.
Unblockable.
Yeah.
Oh, good. Then,
almost. Burst almost saved him from taking that.
Great. Oh, but maybe he can.
Jump D. Hato shot.
Hato shot. Right into the heart.
Yeah, right through the Kokoro.
Yeah.
Okay. So Zumfauge takes it the first round. And okay, Sato pressure starts. Unfortunately.
Mud grab.
No, Eddie.
Eddie is out there. But Sato doesn't need him so far.
Okay, gets out of the corner. This was pretty important.
Yeah. Didn't nice by Sibado.
Yeah, just run away until this Eddie runs out. Doesn't even care about negative penalty.
Yeah. Because if he gets in, he just builds up enough meter. Nice.
That was really
good conversion by Piakar. Maybe we will see a perfect. Crouch under. Oh, block. That man said that a perfect. Nice one by Piakar.
Setups.
Zumfauge respecting that. Looking really, really impressed.
Oh.
That was a wrong set, right?
That was actually plus. I don't know. Or maybe zero, but that was simply the situation where you could not really press anything. That's why. Or maybe Zumfauge did press throw because he knew that. I don't know. It's so
mind
hard.
Games. It's mind games.
It's mind games.
So Zumfauge begins. Oh, drops a combo.
Oh, doesn't cancel to shotgun for once.
Yeah. Because I think he fucked up the timing because he didn't finish the combo.
So Komatsu, it was. You already could see it. Eddie was completely spent. Go for the Komatsu.
Yeah. Oh, nice pressure, by the way.
Forces really, himself really to block with RC.
Yeah. Didn't go for the Komatsu this time. Just back dash.
Anybody's game.
Yeah. Now he doesn't have to fuck up. Nice.
Shadow gallery. Work.
Nobiru.
Oh, that's it. Nah.
Oh, nice overhead finish. Piakar.
And he had so little health, it would be either ship or like something like wacky like this.
But Piakar with a really good offense and adaption. He doesn't just go in and press stuff, he just tried to confirm it. And that was really good.
I think Peter's next. Or me.
Or you?
Yeah, Peter. Peter's next.
And it seems
Piakar doesn't like this idea.
He doesn't want to fuck his own boy. Or
he doesn't want to get fucked, that's it. He smells. They split up the Mexican power.
So,
Czech boys.
Press 1 if you're impressed by Czech boys. Press 2 if you feel Mexican. So two players who play all the time against each other.
Yeah, they know. Both know what to do.
The teacher against the pupil. Let's see, but this time, on this tournament, Piakar did a little bit better than Peter.
I have not seen play them really, but I know that they play.
Yesterday he was like top 6, Peter, and Piakar got third, so it was pretty good.
That's not really important, I think. They have not played against each other. These both players.
Mm.
It's really anybody's game in many, many, many matchups here with the guys who are playing. Anybody can win.
Yeah. So, still the struggle? That should be it, yeah. Go. Yes.
Player 2. Yeah.
Good.
Shoutouts to Account System.
So, let's see. Exa versus Sato. Oh. It's like the typical Guilty Gear matchup. The Axel controls the space. If Eddie isn't out, or if Sato doesn't get the knockdown. But.
Can actually Axel's counter trigger with Eddie and then.
No, I guess not. Because like Eddie is a projectile.
Yeah, so the counter doesn't trigger
it's
with
only
projectiles.
On strike.
Okay.
Throw coin or throw a projectile and it doesn't counter. That would be broken as fuck, man.
Yeah, that's why I asked.
So you couldn't approach X at all.
But I mean, it's the same with it's for me with Sin. Like, he can do that with all my stuff.
Yeah.
That's why I just know it like this.
Yeah. Okay, pretty good start in the beginning.
And it begins.
And it begins.
And another. No, he doesn't go for the immediate again. Yeah.
Good over it.
Odd.
Trying to get out. Bad shadow gallery. He was thinking that Peter would chase him.
Yeah.
So he could catch him off guard. But,
Ah, gets hit.
Gets hit.
I should have killed the bottle.
Yeah. Ah, good catch.
He didn't go for the command strike, right? Like you would expect.
No.
The peace, boys.
Yeah.
Just stuff. You cannot anti-air that.
No, you can't. So Axel doing exactly what he has to do. Playing.
Nice! He did the follow-up to kill Eddie.
Yeah. Can I save?
Yeah, of course, he was put that save, but still he's smart. And Eddie was nowhere near to cover that. And looking very, very, very good for Peter.
Yeah.
Doing and new. You know, and
again.
The fun starts. He got the trade.
Again.
Again, but.
Placing always for the right instance. Doesn't commit too hard to anything.
Oh.
And
he traded. Wow, I'm surprised. Mm. But yeah, anyways. PRK sitting on no meter.
No Eddie yet.
And that's it. Very solid.
Peter knowing the result of matchups and just playing it right.
Just wrecked. Maybe the matchup is pretty hard against Sato, because when Sato struggles, he struggles for the reason that he struggles in neutral.
Yeah, in neutral and in defense.
And neutral is Axel's game, so you could say, might want to say that's really hard for Sato.
Yeah, definitely. So,
I don't think we
I think the last one.
No, Kungster.
It's Kungster and Mick. Mick on our team.
Two more guys. Let's see if Kungster knows how to play the matchup better.
Yeah.
But it could be that he gets blown up.
Could be. I mean, and Kungster always says, he doesn't play the game.
Yeah, that's the option select.
Yeah. So if the option select is really true, then we'll see. But France has, believe, a lot of extra players.
Yeah, Jacquard, for example.
So
comes to mind.
They should. At least it should be known.
Yeah.
Not completely unknown like in Germany, where you.
Yeah, we don't.
Before you didn't know any jack shit about extra.
No.
This was like one of the few characters. And the other character where you don't know jack shit actually is Venom, because there's no good and decent with no bad and decent with Venom. It's just either you're good or you get bodied.
Yeah.
And so you have no really good Venom players, and you don't even know what to fear.
Yeah.
And that's the one character apart from Axel in Germany which also has like this. You don't know. You just don't know because nobody plays. Well, excluding the now new characters.
So, let's begin. Round 2.
Fast normals slash.
Peter with a good win at the start, and now he already has like Zat in the corner. Oh, now
he doesn't even need to, but it's a nice extra.
Yeah.
Jump over.
Ignoring Eddie, but Fungsa trying to regain control in this match. As overhead. Good burst by Peter.
He could have burst it a little later than Eddie would have been spent, but he got out. That's the point.
Yeah.
And that's it. Didn't go for Spark stance, but cross up.
Pass up, catching off guard. Peter really uses it at the right time sometimes.
It's a special you can use, but you don't.
Yeah, not.
You should overuse.
Not overuse, yes. It's like with a command grab with Chip. It's the same.
He was on the ground. No sense in doing the overhead.
Killing Eddie, but.
Didn't get a knockdown out of it, so good trade overall.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, he's back at sandwich time. But commands are incoming.
But he did the Noboru to get.
Punished Sam Summon.
Yeah. Punished
that's just the basic option select with Sato, I mean.
Yeah.
And got too greedy.
Yeah, got too greedy. You have to airblock that.
Don't.
Oh. I don't know.
Two hits. Because it's just not. And he did.
And
solid.
Solid. So, it's the team captain, Mick versus Peter.
Will Peter take it home?
Maybe.
Or will Mick continue the legacy of Team
White.
White. The totally political collect team.
Yes.
I don't know how much. I think Mick won an internally against Peter,
against
so
him, yes.
I think he has at least a good idea what
he said to losers as far as I know. So, especially Mick has pretty good basics and knows the matchups well. Even though he didn't play many, he knows exactly what weaknesses Ram has and tries to, like...
I think it's more about how much Peter knows what he's supposed to go against Ram himself.
The thing is, can you block the mix-ups in the corner?
You cannot.
Cannot.
It's like, again, like set play is always strong.
Mm.
You have to guess right.
Yeah.
Cannot really cut. You have to win in neutral. You just have to win in neutral. And Axel has the stuff to win in neutral.
Yeah,
so.
Definitely.
So let's see.
So, good start by Peter. But Mick respecting that. The Ransom. Okay, already pops the burst. Now, if Mick can get a hit.
Yeah, a lot of hits, but that are just hits, right?
Yeah.
Like, he hit like 5 times already, but look at the HP Mick has lost.
Yeah.
That's the weakness of Axel.
So yes, soap mob, you're more than any other character, so we have to get really good hits.
Yeah, the sword jump-ins can work in Ram's favor.
Yeah. But beat up with good blocks.
Yeah. Just didn't get punished for the... finally gets an anti-air that he can...
Oh, that's pretty big damage right now. The Rens in yellow, I see.
I think he could ship him out.
Nice! Using the 5P and into 2S.
Nice.
To just eliminate both of the swords. Really nice play.
Yeah, if you can do that on point, like, kill the swords, you are good to go.
Yeah.
In any matchup against Randers. Huh?
Yeah. Good start.
Then block high.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, that was really funny.
That's really good, dirty. Oh, nice 2H.
That bot was okay, but didn't hurt Peter so much.
Yeah.
The combo was almost over anyways.
Yeah.
No knockdown, that is. Yeah. He doesn't know how to kill the sword, which is like a little higher. When he's in the air.
He killed it most of the time. But one time he didn't get fit.
Okay. Put the swords away by...
Yeah.
Forcing into rock.
Oh.
That might be it.
No.
Then get it. Nicely done. And Team Red wins. Like I said, Red wins. Red is the leader and always wins. And it's my team. And I won by my presence.
Yeah, good job, man.
I know, I did very well.
Pretty, Peter pretty happy
solid
about
play.
It. Yeah, pretty solid play.
I also beat.